Welcome back, everybody, to Strength and Honor. This is episode 5.
We made it! Look at that!
You made it?
We did it.
We
made it to the next number.
Milestone, bitches.
Lovely. My name's Matt. I'm the DM, and I'm here with...
I'm Ryan.
Nate.
Cassie.
Jens.
Jay.
Jay.
See, only newbies don't like.
All right, so where we left off last week is entirely up to Jens.
Awesome.
It's your turn.
So last week there wasn't a ton of action, but there was a lot of story, but I had a good time. We started off leaving and going back towards the town, towards the inns and bars and restaurants and stuff like that.
But did we?
Yes, we did. In the bar we found out that Elle got kidnapped, which we did not know as characters. We found out that Sepetan is a little bit of a lush, maybe turning into an alcoholic.
Can't wait.
You should read my notes.
We found out about some children that are being kidnapped and...
Oh, yeah.
Children.
Yeah. Children. It's fucked up. And then I had an early evening that evening, so we woke up real early and went to the Mage's College. For some reason, I have magic, because I was able to touch the sword thing that allowed books to come to us.
Books coming.
We saw the Beholder, who is probably my favorite NPC at this
point. Oh, we need to bring him with us. He will be my pet.
His name is Chocolesso. He was fabulous.
We have to be our
nanny. Yes!
And then we met the headmaster of the Mages College, Gaius. Okay, that's what I thought. And he led us into the library, and he let Knots go and try to find someone that he was looking for, and then I went home because I'm a pansy and I wanted to sleep.
Good note! An extra 3 experience to you for that
time. No, I'll give you the full 200 even though you left out buying people dinner, but that's cool.
Oh, yeah, you did buy...
I did buy dinner, but, I mean...
It's okay,
nothing really happened at dinner.
I'm really happy of your recap because I forgot almost all of that.
Jesus.
So that's funny because you know all of that's the most...
So what do we do as the pants left?
Right. So, where everybody stands now, Knots and L are on the training spire top. Having a very in-depth conversation. Sepetan and Varys and Hadrian are still down in the library.
That's right.
So, we'll lead off with where Knots and L are right now, after your very intense conversation.
Right. So, now that we shared that about ourselves...
We don't remember what we shared. It will be.
Okay, that's exciting to know. Glad we had that talk. Same thing about my shit. And I have no reason to share your shit. Yeah.
Well, shit.
Nobody. Let's see. Don't worry, darling. You say that a lot to me, so just let it happen. The important thing is, should we get back to everyone else, or do we want to look into more of the awesome thing? Not that terrible part of the awesome thing, but
the awesome thing. What part of that was awesome? We all look pretty fucked up.
It's only awesome for you.
The strange voice in my head is completely right. Yes, it is only awesome for me.
So,
but
you go play, I will go find the children.
Okay. I had a thought, I totally lost it, but the important part is, don't you want help with that? No, you don't. I'm L. I'm awesome.
That is true. I'm glad you're finding that out.
This is again. Do we want to find everyone else? I'll go talk to you. I got a few more questions and then I'll catch up.
Awesome. See you later, Sparky. And I walk back downstairs.
Sparky? What the fuck is Sparky?
Those sparks spark. making note of that.
You didn't hear that.
I don't care. I just want to remember it.
Right.
Okay.
Sparky is apparently going to go to talk to this wonderful man.
Okay. So as you go back into the workshop, Guns is still like heavily scribbling down all kinds of notes and shit like that, just frantically as you walk in.
So, how's it going?
Oh, it's going well. Like, I think I actually have a pretty decent plan for all this. I don't quite have the parts list together for the actual, like, main weapon, but I'm pretty sure that I could cobble something together for you to use the war core now.
Why?
Yeah. It turns out that each one of the cores could possibly be used to power a single weapon. It won't be nearly as powerful as the main weapon once we complete it, but I could cobble together something really quick here in about half a day if you want me to.
Yes.
Okay. So it's gonna, like I said, just give me half a day. Also, since you're here, I know you said you're traveling with a bunch of people, right? Did I overhear that correctly?
Yeah.
Okay, so I have, as you saw in my notes, I have a whole bunch of notes of a bunch of different styles of other things I can make. The only thing I would need is a little bit of funding and a little help with getting the materials. Materials can be found pretty much anywhere. You can buy them at shops. You can, like some of the metal work and the gemstone work, you can go and mine up in Ironhole. You could find all of it if you wanted to. And some of this stuff, if I put it together correctly, could be pretty powerful. So, I will leave that to you to let everybody know, but I can kind of get you a makeshift list of the things I have that I could make now. Okay, I will throw that together to you and get it to you in just a little bit. But first of all, I want to finish putting together this list of stuff we need for this thing, because yikes. Because that's got to happen.
Yikes.
Do you have any other questions or anything? Or?
You said funds. How much would you need?
For the other weapons or for the main weapon?
The fun one.
I'm not quite sure yet. From what I saw when we all touched the core, this entire machine appeared to me that will pretty much fill the room, so it'll take a little bit of money. I don't really know for sure. It really just depends on, you know, how quickly you get the cores and whether or not any of your other friends want to help build any of these other things or whatnot, any of these other weapon ideas I have. Some of them might even work for you now that I think about it, but yeah. Once I get a full list together of all the things I need and probably the amount of money required to build a machine to actually put this fucking thing back together, mm-hmm. I'll definitely let you know, because it will probably be a pretty penny. So.
Oh, that's kind.
Right.
What were the things that I could use that you may have or may build?
I had this idea for a style of kind of a gun like you use, that it's kind of a rifle, and what it does is it focuses a combination of all three elements into a single beam style weapon that disrupts matter and whatnot, and does absurd amount of damage that can't be, like, once that shit's dead, it's dead. So that's something I know how to build right now. I also know how to make a basically throwable pocket versions of spells. I call them grenades. And basically, all you'd have to do is just take it and you just pull this release lever and throw it. And I can make them in all kinds of different styles, from like fire, ice, poison, anything you'd need. And I mean, on top of that, I have, for other people, I have a machine that could be programmed to fire a specific style of spell pretty much indefinitely as it follows the user around. I have a really strange idea for a weapon that's an arm-mounted, rotating blade that could do some pretty wicked damage. I have an idea for an item that literally you would fire it at something, and it has like a long chain and a blade at the end, and you could either use it to pull enemies to you or pull yourself to enemies. If you have... Hey, you could come in handy.
Here I come.
Especially...
I think unless there's wheels or spikes that go down and go anchor him in place.
Otherwise, I also know a way to create a style of clothing, probably in robe format, that... Or any other kind of just basic clothing. It wouldn't have much for like defensive armor capability, but what it can do is it literally would have the ability to stop any damage you take. Period. It would take a while for it to recharge because it'd be powered by fucking crystal these powered crystals that I know how to make, but in essence, it could basically just stop any form of damage you might take. If you know any archers, I know how to make explosive, and also these styles of arrows that would blind the enemy as well.
Don't know any archers.
And then I also know how to make a style of weapon that could easily turn from a sword to a spear and into like a scythe style weapon, depending on the necessity required.
I don't think anyone would want to use it.
Okay, but yeah. Pass any of that information along. And
this is a bitch, whoever that is.
And any of the money that you guys pay me to make these things, I can certainly put towards building what we need to build here, so.
Do you have anything current and or recently made that could help me in a long-range scale?
In a long-range scale. Well, if that's what you would...
As of right now.
At this moment, I do not, unfortunately. But, like I said, if you give me half a day, I have the material here to put together a weapon that we could fashion the war core into, and I could get it back to you, like I said, pretty soon. If you would prefer it be a long range weapon, or I could do a short range scatter style weapon. I mean, any kind of. I figured you were going for firearms, so whatever kind of firearm you'd prefer, I can design with the stuff I have here. I have just enough materials here to build something that would probably work for you.
That war core sounds really promising.
Yeah. So what kind of weapon do you want me to put together for it?
Range?
Okay. I will make note of that, and then I guess
Well, I guess could I have it be versatile?
I don't know. I mean, I can maybe, now that I think about it. I might be able to fashion it a way where if you take the time, even on the battlefield, to just make a few adjustments on the fly. Yeah, I don't see why not. I could make something that could be versatile in that regard.
Amazing.
Okay. But yeah, I'll get working on that right away, and I'll get together that list of not only the stuff I'll need for the Four Horsemen itself, but also from the vision where we... got clues whereas the other ones would be. Because it showed me pretty much, as of right now, what I believe are the resting places for the other three. It's just a matter of going and getting them.
All right. Well, you need funds. What if I gave you 500 gold?
Oh, that
gets you started.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, that's perfect. That'd be more than enough to...
Great friends.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely, I'm looking forward to getting this done. I'm kind of just feverish now at the idea of getting this thing built. I mean, it's terrifying. It's truly terrifying. But
no, okay.
No? Oh, okay. Well, good. That kind of puts my mind at ease because I was kind of worried that building this thing was a bad idea and really dangerous. But
I can think of a couple.
Oh. You're a bad idea. As long as
100% true.
At this point, pretty much, yeah.
Sorry, 1,000% true.
But yeah, okay, I'll get started on this weapon in the list, and then just come back and see me in like half a day.
Awesome.
And I should be able to cobble something together.
I might have something going on in a bit, but I'll come back.
Okay. Sounds good.
Also, one thing I just thought of. I can't really get in. No magic.
Oh!
Do you have something?
That's true. Yes. Let me just, really quick, I'll just write something up.
I'm surprised you didn't promise his money away, Considering he's noble, and he likes to keep reminding us of that.
If I remember to talk to Seth.
Okay. Let's just hold on to this, and just whenever you want to get back in, just show that.
Awesome.
Says, hear ye, hear ye. I have to take a shit. Thank you.
Pretty much.
Love the smiley face.
Well, that was a smiley face! That's adorable.
Awesome.
All right. Okay. Anything else?
Not too much.
No? Okay. Okay. I'm going to get started then. Okay. So, you three are still down. Jesus fucking Christ.
Nice!
Well, considering you both saw right where everybody was going, you know exactly where to find. So, jump down to the library, and you three are still in there. At what?
Legacy books.
Legacy books.
Besides talking to Cyrillo, the crown, and finding all that stuff out, I don't remember if there was something that we did afterwards to, like, it was just, that was where we cut.
No, yep.
He was like, you just put it on and it was done.
Yep.
Okay. Then,
do you guys get all the information you needed?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm kind of away from them though, right?
Yeah. Right. Yes. You do now also notice that when you wear the crown, you actually see like a ghostial image of Zerlo.
Oh, I see him?
Yes.
Oh, that's sweet. What's he look like?
Just from what you can tell, considering the amount of energy he has is so weak, it's kind of like a phantasmal outline of a person. You can't make out a lot of details.
Oh, that's terrifying, actually.
Yeah.
I didn't want to know that. Can we rewind real quick?
No. No.
Okay, sorry. Zerlo, is there anything else that you think that we might need to know right now? You know what we're doing, correct?
You're looking for a ruby, correct?
There's also the children that we were going to help.
That is entirely news to me. I mean, the most I can do is, if it's a risk, but if you have a suspect in mind or something and you want me to take a look into their mind, you can have them touch the crown. Aside from that, I can't really do much aside from let you see pretty much what I'm allowing you to see now, which is the basic magical essence of any being you look at. Okay. As long as you choose to focus on them, you can see their aura and the level, basically the coloration. It should at least give you a little bit of a hint when it comes to these situations.
So at this point, do you think there's anything else we need to talk about at this moment?
Aside from, as I said, are you clear on how this process would need to go?
Yes.
Okay. You just let me know. If you have any other questions, it's kind of hard for me to gauge right now how I'll be able to help you until my magical capabilities reach a level where I'm capable of helping you.
Well, let's see where everything takes us at this point. I'm just kind of along for the ride.
Okay.
That was no pun intended.
I wasn't aware of a pun intended. Or unintended.
Moving on.
Okay.
I'm going to go find those guys.
Okay. Well, considering they're right on the other side of a big pilot
table.
Yeah.
I guess I was gonna be like.
It's like if this is a big square of tables, you're at that corner, they're over at this corner just like.
But it's a stand up table, so he's underneath it.
Right. There's just like his head balancing on the table.
Roll under the table.
Okay, then I guess I just roll over again then. Varys, Adrian?
Are we ready to go? We're supposed to go to the orphanage.
Other? Yes.
Other.
Okay, did you guys get any more information on Legacy?
No.
I'm just going to drop a pile of books on you.
Sure, we'll be remembering last week, which you
roll
to see
what's happening in the deck.
That's a lot of books.
So, yeah. Basically, they quickly relay everything that they learned last week, which you probably don't remember. So,
huh. I have. There's a few notes. Well, I guess we could probably get these books back, and then, yes, I think we're ready.
Go on.
Go. Are we going to the orphanage first, or are we going to get the ruby?
The ruby, not the orphanage. We need to go. Is
that the orphanage? Yes, you're right.
So at this point, first L walks in.
What's up, bitches? Find some shit?
We're going to the orphanage.
Well, good. I thought
that
was the plan.
Yeah. That
was the plan.
Where's
Nuss?
He's coming.
Okay. Don't worry. He found a new toy.
You found a new toy?
What do you mean you found a new toy?
I don't know. Blow shit up. It shows you better shit. It's not fun. Also, one thing I left off is he gave it to you. You now have it in a box as of right now.
Great. That's so fucking cool! Start the tallies up!
We're gonna start tallies up.
Start the tallies up!
This time we will have a tally for it.
I'll be honest, I'm already at three.
I like that.
It is,
yeah.
Put your hips back right there.
Right.
Jeez. Anti-material rifle. Oh my god.
TSC. Oh, FC. There we go.
There we go.
Yay!
It has begun!
It's about time you had more than one character on the board.
Right.
You're not enough characters.
Right.
Right. Nick, let's just draw a card. Don't add tablets.
So after a little bit longer, Knott's comes walking in.
See? Told you he's coming.
Ta-da.
Do you have your new toy?
No.
What is it? We got told about your new toy.
Yeah, it's
a new one. Can I roll a CP9?
Sure. That's not the toy. That's not the toy she's talking about.
Yeah.
I'll roll to see if I beat that.
You beat a six.
They're gonna work here!
Bitch!
Sucker whore!
I'm not more!
Everything belongs to me!
You failed me.
So as you guys.
Jesus.
Wow.
After everything I found out about, it's okay.
Right. Things out of control. So you guys are all standing around chit-chatting. At this point, Gaius walks back in.
I just wanted to make sure you all found what it is you were looking for.
Yep.
Everything good?
Yes, actually.
Yes, excellent, excellent. All right, well, I will leave you to it. Let me know if you have any other questions. We have other mages here that might be of help too, depending on what you need. There's all kinds of mages in the college if you have any questions. I can point you to the right mage.
Well, I know I'll probably be back. I enjoy this place.
Yeah, we should move.
I'll be back.
Okay. Okay. Everybody make a perception check.
Oh, snap.
Do you want a box, fucktard?
15.
Perception?
Yes.
23.
Fuck! 22.
So who got, so you got over 20?
Yeah.
Did anybody else?
22.
22?
Three.
So.
Oh. Love this lover's quarrel here between my wife and one of my closest friends.
Oh no.
You said it the last session.
No.
Did I?
Yeah.
All right.
So as you guys are about ready to leave the library, you two hear this first as well as feel it. As there is a rippling wave of heat that flows through the Mages College, and you guys hear what sounds like five distinct, like these rumbling, very light exploding noises. After a bit, the other three of you do but not only hear, but feel them as well.
Do we know where
they're
coming from?
Like, which direction?
It'd be an investigation, yeah.
Ooh, you were mine. That was not 8.
21.
You said that was 18. Perception again?
20.
Investigation. What the fuck does matter? This thing, I had 11.
Okay. So as you guys kind of discern that it's, I mean, considering where you are in the library, you can tell it's coming from more towards the direction of the main room. As you walk out into the main room, Gaius is already standing there looking very concerned about the noises and the the effect. You can actually, at this point, see the effect. Like, you know how you see heat ripples on the sidewalk or on the concrete? It's kind of like that, but you can see it at different points in the entire of the room, and it seems to be spreading.
Well, that doesn't look good.
And Gaius is like, oh no, that's not good.
Oh, great.
Gaius?
That's fabulous. I'm so happy we're here.
And he's like, junk! And the air and then in front of them in the main room parts, and this large beholder appears again. He's like, hey, what's up? What? Junko, what is going on? Oh, I don't know. What? Why should I know? Because it's your job to ensure the safety of the college. Oh, yeah. Okay. All right. Give me a second. And all of his eyeball tentacles just fan in every direction. You just look around everywhere really quickly, darting all over the place.
God, I know.
My favorite.
And then he looks back down at Gaius and goes, "Where? I can't really do anything about it.
Why is that, Junko?
It's coming from Resco's room.
Fuck.
Whoa.
Well, I suppose we should go see what's going on.
And Junko just kind of like bashfully kind of floats backwards and very slowly materializes back into like invisibility.
Gaius?
Yes?
What's going on? We overheard some things. What was that?
Well, it seems like one of my colleagues may have succeeded in his work in a way that is very crappy. He has been here for a long time, and he sealed up his area of the wing, which makes it impossible for Junko to even get in there. I suppose I should go check on it, because if he succeeded what I think he might have succeeded in, this is a bad thing. This is a very bad thing. Would you all like to accompany me?
It might be
dangerous. I'm just letting you know now.
That sounds fine.
Okay. Right this way.
And he takes you back down to a main staircase that's in the back of the foyer. And as you walk / bonk down the stairs, it breaks off into two other ones that fan out and go down to two other separate sides. You go down the left side, and as you're going down the hall, you guys can adamantly feel the heat just becoming more and more unbearable. And then as you near the end of the hall, you see a door that is slightly ajar. Everybody make a perception check, quick.
Oh, wow.
20.
Ah, that's a natural
22.
One.
22.
Natural one.
I got a 3.
20, not natural.
Nice. Okay.
Receptive as fuck.
So anybody above 10 sees a charred corpse laying on the ground right outside the door. The door is slightly ajar only because it's being slightly held ajar by this corpse's foot. You can see waves of heat emanating from this crack in the door, as well as hearing this, like, the whoosh of, like, fire. Like, when you have a torch and you whip it back and forth, that whooshing noise it makes, you hear that as going back and forth inside the room, along with flashes of light emanating from the crack in the door.
Oh, no, this isn't good.
As Gaius leads you guys up to the corpse, he looks down. Oh.
What is this?
That was Resco.
This is the guy
yes.
who was doing the experiment.
Yes.
What was he working on?
I don't really know. Something about physical animation of elements. He was trying to find a way to create his own elementals for him to actually use.
Make an investigation check.
You want to loot a charred corpse?
Yeah.
There's nothing!
It's all cursed!
Yes!
I'm happy you let that play out just to yell at her.
What are you checking that for?
So I'm just imagining it like everybody's like, oh, this is awful, and I was just like.
Does he have a pulse?
No! He's a fucking potato chip.
I'm not the one who's touching.
What's a potato chip?
I don't know, but it sounds delicious. Whatever he succeeded in is still in the room. Are you sure you all want to step in there? It might be dangerous.
Can it leave the room?
Maybe. I don't know what
it
is.
Give us 1 second, and I'm just going to usher everyone kind of back a bit. Do we actually want to take care of this right now? Mine is a yes.
It'll put us in a good standing in college, so...
Okay, yeah, but there are children, and there are children, and my fucking room.
But what if the thing gets out?
Well, we can deal with that.
Make a quick perception check.
Fuck off!
18.
Okay, so you all rolled high enough, so at this point you do actually see flames licking out of the doorway now.
That seems like something
capable. And,
guys, do you have any way of stopping this?
At most I can do is keep it contained once we go in to check it out.
Okay, you're fire retardant. Go ahead.
Can we get
resistant, not retarded,
after they open the door?
No, because Resco specifically built this to be his sanctuary. He didn't want, sorry, Junko, prying eyes.
I don't think Resco is it.
All you
it's
hear is,
anymore.
Oh yeah, it's bullshit.
I don't think we have much of a choice. We're here now. It needs to be taken care of.
Yes, I agree.
All right.
Thank you.
Shink.
All right.
Adrian, you go first.
Excuse me, can you pull
he's still hot!
Thank you. Okay.
So as Gaius goes over to the door, he's like, all right, you ready? Okay. As he goes like one, two, three, and really slowly opens the door.
I'm gonna back up against the wall.
I'm just gonna kind of stand there, just whatever.
Everybody make perception checks from the doorway.
Natural 20, baby.
Oh, shit.
13.
9.
Started bad, moving my way up.
14. I had 2 great rolls. One for a terrible insight check, and one for a perception check.
Do-do-do-do-do.
Both of you. Fuck off. Especially you.
Okay.
Shut
gain
up.
Gain 500 experience.
Gain 500
yes.
experience?
That's an achievement. Rolling a natural 20 in the Mage's College.
Fuck you! That's awesome!
Why did I have
is that her first achievement?
Yes.
Bing, 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 bing,
bing!
Aside from
so
the constant one
happy.
That,
right.
For update.
Fuck yeah!
Or recap, I mean. So, as you look in, you do see the room is on fire, but there's something, you see specifically, there's something interesting about this fire, is that the fire will catch in places and then go back out like it's moving.
Oh.
Like, you legitimately see, like, these five trails of fire moving along, and they'll stay at a spot, scorch something pretty much to ash, and then continue on. Also, when you specifically, Ryan, look in the room, you can make out, like, much of the room is still intact as these things are still just, like, bounding around. Like, you can see almost something childlike in nature about these flaming entities as they move around the room. Like, they're just kind of testing out their capabilities at this time.
This is purely for possible spells.
Right.
How big is this room? Like, is it a tall ceiling and everything?
It does have about a 16, actually more like a 20-foot ceiling.
Perfect. That's
there, in the center, there is a round table that has a giant held, like, a crystalline shape held together by a contraption that basically looks like a bunch of... diamonds or a bunch of gemstones literally cut down and made into puzzle pieces so that they can be put together in a way.
Okay.
And whatnot.
Wanted to get a lay of the room.
Otherwise, inside you can also make out just about anything you would pretty much see in any mage's room. Like, there's like bookshelves that are, some of them are burnt, some of them are not, all kinds of experimentation kind of materials and whatnot. Yep, magic dildos. As well as you see a bunch of cages over on the left side as well. The rest of you can make out the layout of the room just visually from in there, the giant centerpiece, the open area around it, the trails of fire, but you just can't make out a lot of the details. It's just a little bit too bright and hot. Like you're just kind of like, Jesus Christ.
Can you describe the little entity's size comparatively to like a person?
As of right now, they're about... yay big, but they move in like a fluid motion, so it's kind of hard to get an idea of their shape.
So they're like baby sized.
Yes.
Like a toddler, yeah.
Okay. I was
going to
think,
I just stopped them out. Yeah, they're like this big, are they considered
giant? Can I actually play a song? And just sound better, right?
What? Yeah, song?
No.
That bar mitzvah song, it stuck in his fucking head last week.
Is this guy that got burned up? Did you say he's five? I lost the war.
I'm pretty sure he's had his one pun session.
Yep.
I'm good. I'm set.
Oh, is it one pun per session?
No, it's one pun.
Okay, good. So I can save it.
Okay. You had to get your fucking.
You're just jealous.
No.
I'm gonna grab some pins along and use it as a toothpick.
It's coming from the guy who's always complaining that everybody's so mean to the kid, too.
I'm gonna reduce his penis.
Why are you so mean?
Switch and
pen.
Switch
and
pen.
Switch
and
pen. Congratulations, you casted Levitate on a creature that
you'll
can already
shoot your eye out.
You'll shoot your eye out. Okay.
You're completely immobile from the waist down. There's no way your wrist works that well.
Thul,
works.
As you all are like right outside the door here,
you're all pricks.
So,
what are you guys gonna do?
Huh? What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? What? Yeah. You can make out fire moving throughout the room. You just can't make out like the specific. You guys can make out pretty much everything I told him, except for specifics about the room. You're so distracted by the scene of like the fire things.
Even other times.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're looking right in the room. I mean, you're more of just like.
I pushed up against the wall.
Right. At this point, it's more like those who can't see as much are like just like ah. You know how when it's like a hot wind blows in your face, you just kind of like.
Is there a water basin in the room?
I don't know. Roll another perception check.
I was gonna say, can I roll another power check to see if I can find out if.
Sure.
The flames can be brought 19. By a specific...
19, there is not.
By anything in particular, which that's a 19.
You can tell that there probably was one, but it has probably boiled away at this point.
Okay, so 19 are not...
You're rolling to see what these are?
Yeah, I want to see what they are and like if they can be like put out by anything, like water, wind, anything, or if it's purely...
Pocket sand.
Pocket sand, which I do have, so...
At this point, what you can make out... is specifically, these are entities that are still trying to get the lay of their own physical self. They're slowly becoming something else.
So they're totally
they are not entirely just fire. And they're not what you classically know of as a fire elemental. Okay. So the same effects that you have read about in your studies to combat fire elementals, you look at these things and you're like, that's not quite what I think of. Because fire elementals, as you've read, are pretty much just like... a standing embodiment in a physical form
sure.
of an element.
So these are pretty much, it is pretty much magical fire, but it can be touched physically, it can be...
You can tell specifically it has, I mean, it's acting like it has a mind. It's just trying to figure out what it's doing with itself right now.
Sure.
It's lashing out because it doesn't know quite what it wants to do. So. Okay. So who's all entering the room?
I'm
going to
step back for now and
burn
the doorway.
Ellie's just
going to...
Okay, so as soon as you all take the two of you who step foot in the room, the little dancing fires pretty much stop. They just kind of like rise off of wherever they were like resting and burning stuff and just kind of hover there for a second. Like they're waiting for you guys.
Hello, guys.
That's your plan? Talk to them?
What was your plan?
They look small, like children.
That's exactly what I thought of, too.
Okay, I guess I don't like everything better at the moment.
What do you want to do? Extinguish them with water if you can, but I'm not water.
at the sound of the word extinguish, they all kind of jut forward by about 3 feet towards you.
No.
Slowly creep forward, hands out.
So just to give you an idea as to where each one of them is at this point, like one here.
Somebody go get one.
Get her.
No, we got a guy on wheels. He's fine.
So, creeping forward, it's okay. We're here to talk. Can you guys talk?
So as you creep forward, every time you move forward, they move forward a little bit more towards you. Yeah, they kind of do. They're like, like they're reacting to your movements.
Yeah. We're never gonna be able to catch up.
Scooch a little bit closer and, hey, little buddy.
So, yeah, like I said, as you guys move forward, they just kind of hover there.
Is there anything wooden in the room around me?
A lot.
Oh, there's plenty. Yeah. These are tables over here. There's a giant metal table in the center with the suspended thing that's in there. There's a kind of like a, fuck Christ, I just forgot the word, dining room table over here, and there's a partition back there, and through the slightly burnt partition you can see a bed, basically living quarters.
Is there anything on here?
These are cages over here.
Cages?
Yes.
Cages?
Cages meant for all kinds of things, from small cages to large cages. If you want to make a perception check for what's inside.
Or like,
the red room of pain.
Right!
Just that corner.
Sick fuck.
Just that what one perception is
19.
Okay, you can make out that there are a few cages with different styles of creatures cowering in the back of them. Anything ranging from like your normal everyday rabbit in a small cage to No people.
No, they put them in cages.
Birds.
And do they look angry or scared?
Scared. They all look scared.
Like breakfast.
It's pretty much, yeah, any creature that you would see. The largest creature would be like a dog or a panther.
Or a panther?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought
you said panda. I was like, fucking pandas! There's even some cages you can't make out what's in them, but you can tell there's something in them.
Okay.
I'd actually like to walk like directly up to one. Carefully making it like.
Okay, which one?
Let's go from the one by the table there.
Here?
Yeah.
So as you get about halfway to it, it actually jumps up and really quickly rushes back, slams into the other one back there. It increases in size by twice fold. Then that one rushes to the other one and does the exact same thing, increasing each time exponentially. Until all five of them have been completely absorbed into one flame.
Nope.
And then,
why do you have to go and do that?
Not again.
And then as they become one large flame, it actually like moves over to right in front of here and just hovers there for a second. This is now like, for lack of a better term, like about an 8 foot size open fire, just standing there hovering in midair.
You speak common? Speak elvish?
Nothing.
I don't think it's gonna talk to us, guys.
Ask if it speaks in infernal.
I mean, it won't understand unless I actually speak infernal.
Fuck in base.
Face! I love that face.
It'd be more like this.
In Infernal, I ask, do you speak Infernal?
You kind of hear the sound of it. God, this is really hard to explain. That same whooshing sound of flame as it's being moved around, you hear that in like beats and like bits, kind of like a Morse code style, vainly attempting to communicate.
Kind of like the
it understands the you, but it cannot respond to you.
I'm out of ideas. It can understand me is what I'm gathering with the click clicks.
Okay.
But then again, I have no fucking clue.
I want to walk over to the gate.
Okay. So as you get to about halfway, the flame starts to really quickly spin around this center metal table and starts to move more towards the center. As it moves towards the center, it actually starts to envelop the table and the crystal. And after, as you watch, it actually starts to pull apart the table, like melting it down and pulling apart the crystal into tiny pieces, as well as like all the fixtures and pieces holding it, literally just devouring everything inside of its fire. And then as you see all the pieces like come together in the center, you actually see the flame pretty much just shatter. And once again, firing fire to basically those same five spots. And basically what you see land there is like this hunk and shape of all the stuff that was in the middle, just spread out over five smaller things. And as you just kind of stare in awe at this situation, I assume.
Okay. Yeah. No, I don't care. I've seen that before.
You actually see them start to move. Kind of, yes. As of this point, they're about yay big of like just a hunk of mass. And as you watch, they start to like rewrite themselves like they're actually coming into a shape as they alter and basically flex themselves. What's up?
Can I make like a history check to see if I understood, like, if there's anything I would have learned about these idiots more? We're at a loss here.
Okay, yeah, quick.
Yeah.
13? 13, you've heard of elemental-based constructs in other formats. Things referred to as lesser elementals. But that's about it. So as you watch these things, they actually start to right themselves, turning into a more humanoid shape, composed of the metal and wood and stone that was eaten up from the middle. As they all just like stand up and kind of turn to look at you. As you look at each one, they kind of look like just a pale-faced dwarven shape. And then as they slowly open their eyes are just plain fire. And as they look at each one of you, they just have this blank stare, and all of a sudden their heads are just consumed in flame. And one by one, each one of them creates a weapon out of like the pieces of metal it was created out of, as well as fire. Does anybody want to do anything?
Gust of wind, dance! I just shoot it at one of them. I've had enough!
What does that do now?
So a line of strong wind, 60 feet long and 10 feet wide, blasts from you in a direction you choose for the spell's duration.
Did you just say that you added a bunch of oxygen to fire creatures?
Time to put it out.
No, oxygen bad. They're going to explode.
I'm okay with this.
No one else was doing anything. Fuck off. No one else was doing anything. I resort to violence.
I'm going to go let all of
them. I'm going to unite.
I am going to violence.
They are magic based, so it's not like the real flame. You have to make it must succeed on a strength saving throw or be pushed back 15 feet away from you in a direction following the line. Any creature in the line must spend 2 feet of movement for every 1 foot it moves when moving closer to you. The gust disperses gas or vapor and extinguishes candles, torches, and similar unprotected flames in the area. It causes protected flames, such as those of lanterns, to dance wildly and has a 50% chance
per
to
chance.
Extinguish them.
Per chance.
Well, luckily these guys are.
You know what?
No.
Here, I'll just hand you the fucking card.
I don't care. Just what do I have to do for a save and what damage does it do?
What's your DC?
It doesn't do damage.
It just pushes shit.
Yes.
Thank God.
It pushes stuff back and it extinguishes flames.
Okay.
Small flames.
Torches.
Like
candles.
Torches. Torches, candles, protected flames, those are lanterns. All that kind of stuff.
It doesn't extinguish lanterns. You said they dance wildly.
Like he said, it has a 50% chance. That's what I said.
Yeah, perchance, chance.
Awesome, so basically, you have to make a strength saving throw, and that's when if you fail it, then you get pushed back. Then I'm assuming it's kind of up to you if they put out something.
Which one are you aiming at?
I'm gonna assume the closest one to me. It's a 60 foot. How far is this guy? I'm just curious.
40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 70.
So close, so that guy.
Okay, so you are firing it, hopefully past him.
It's 10 feet wide, so yeah, I'll hit.
Yeah, you'll hit Varys.
Yeah, but it just pushes, so that make a strength saving throw?
Yes.
Yeah, the strength saving throw, you have to beat a 14. Okay, I get pushed 10 feet that way.
So you are now pushed 10 feet towards this thing as it literally just like anchors itself and bears through the wind. And you do notice that like the flame on its head kind of goes out and just kind of comes to a rest for a bit. And after a while you see like embers start to flicker back on its head a little bit. So why doesn't everybody go ahead and roll initiative? Okay, so that's lovely. Christ.
And actually, you get pushed 15 feet. So you're right. Behind. Oh yeah, by the way. Right next to him.
Oh Christ. Okay.
It's okay. They're probably
still. So, I mean, everyone else is just sitting there. Things aren't friendly.
We didn't know that until.
I like how it says these things aren't friendly when I stated that they are communicating.
Yeah, and they're also pulling weapons out to attack us before I did anything.
They could just be defending themselves.
Every time you've pulled out a weapon, Knox, you've wanted to attack, so I'm going off of what you do.
Girls, you're both pretty.
First off, I lost my train of thought. I don't want to argue with someone.
Have you had anything to drink today?
No.
There's the problem.
Now why don't we get through this issue before we start figuring at each other again, please?
This is part of the fun.
Oh, it's wrong. It doesn't speak Infernal. How is that a language?
Oh, the
Ignan.
Yes.
It is literally the sound of crackling fire.
Okay, I'm glad I described that.
I know, Ignan. Light a torch to communicate.
Okay, Ryan, what was your initiative?
Just imagine talking and campfire.
Yeah, all
Nate.
The elementals have like their own language.
Initiative.
14. I rolled a 5.
I'm disappointed.
Me too.
Cass?
10.
I don't want to talk about my rolls.
Jay-Z? Jay-Z! I gotta do something in my notes.
Oh,
G.
14.
Jay?
Yeah. Jay? Wow. Well, good job, Sepitam.
Great initiative.
Okay, so.
I have a great feeling that's gonna kill all of us.
Last.
And just like that, we're gonna have a new cast next session. Yes, I did throw my race. I had so much fun planning all of our shit, and then it's like, oh,
now
well,
the
okay.
The children are full.
Can we let the animal go?
Yeah.
They might be able to help us. Or...
Can you talk to animals?
Can we barbecue?
I'm just going to ask that. Listen, I'm call it out.
He's right by the door.
Cool.
Like, he was pretty much waiting for all of you to go in and considering not.
I just imagine him sitting there clipping his toenails. You got this.
I believe in you!
Like a sloth just slowly moving.
Now remember, this isn't a test. Before we do this, did you want to take a break?
You asking me?
Well, no, I was asking
you. Oh, okay.
Yeah, it sounded like you wanted to.
No, he said, do you want
to
stand
on
the cages?
Oh, I thought you were talking about... Never mind.
Okay.
Yes, I
want to
take a break.
No. You don't get
to take a break.
You're going to roll for everyone.
No.
Yeah, I would kill all of us.
Okay. So you got pushed to that one. All right. So top of the order is. Nope. Natural 20.
We're all fucked.
Okay. Now. Ship it. Ship it.
I'm gonna move up as far as I can, so 30 feet, towards Varys. And on the one right in front of him, I'm gonna cast, this is my second level spell, I'm gonna cast Ray of Enfeeblement.
Okay.
Black Beam of, make a ranged spell attack against a target on a hit. The target deals only half damage with weapon attacks that use strength until the spell ends, and it lasts for 1 minute.
Oh, okay.
So, that's going to be a 21.
To hit?
Yep.
Hit.
So, yeah, so now it doesn't do damage. It's just now he deals half damage on strength until the spell ends, so 1 whole minute. That
concentration.
And at, yes, it is. At the end of each of the target's turns, it can make a constitution saving throw against the spell. On a success, the spell ends. So, that was my turn.
Okay.
As they conjure weapons in front of us? Sure.
Okay. Knots.
Junes? Is that his name, right? June? What's the guy's name?
Gaius.
Sorry, I'm reading these names.
Junes!
I'm great. I'm set for tonight. Don't worry, guys. I'm gonna die. No. I just want to look to him. What keeps the beholder from going in? Could he help us if we got rid of that?
Well, basically, the entire room is filled with an enchantment that will keep him out. But what I can do is I can bridge the gap for him to use abilities through me. I don't know how much of an effect they would have on these things, but it's not impossible for him to help through me.
Sorry, I'm
gassy. Well, any little bit helps.
All right.
But yes. Junko, should we do this like we tried?
What? You realize that last time I tried this, I almost killed you, right? That's... Can you even... can you even aim this thing?
I'll do my best. Okay.
So he steps to the doorway, and basically what he does is he kind of stands halfway in and halfway out, puts one hand behind himself, and puts one hand forward. And let's see. Mother of glass.
Terrible.
Yeah. Oh, it's on terrible.
Yeah, I'm going with the ladder.
Just slowly reach for my superior healing potion and apparently question everything I've just done. Not really.
Okay. I did not expect this to happen, so.
This could be good or terrible.
Did we just kill the Archmage?
No! Jesus Christ. Okay, so thank God for Nate being a fucking genius.
He just took them all out.
So as he does this, you see Jungle Epso appear behind him, and all of the eyes kind of funnel around into a shape around him, and really quickly, each of the eyes light up at one point, and then light up the center eye, as they all fire this heavy black beam straight into the hand of Gaius, and Gaius just lets forth this pure black beam that vaporizes this entire enemy. See, the worst part is that I'm like, well, this is going to be silly because all of his rays are pretty much pointless against these. Fuck, it's got disintegrate. It's literally what I did. I'm like, none of these are even useful in this fight. Fuck.
How about an insta-kill?
Yes, okay. So yes, one is now completely vaporized.
Cool. Cool.
That was mine.
And Gaius is like, I don't know how much more of that I can take, but... As you do notice, there is actual scarring on the inside palms of both of his hands.
I'm just gonna gingerly push him outside the room. Thanks.
Okay.
Your job is done here.
Now it is your turn. As that one was
being a fucking boss with that
fucking
one,
vapor.
Time to ruin it.
Sorry, I
beat
you to it.
No, it's gonna happen. How far away is this guy right here?
From you? 75.
75?
That's pretty much what...
Same
yeah.
And then how about the one next to... Scary?
40.
Do I have line of sight on
him? I should be just out of your way.
Yes.
Pull a pepper box and go to
round though. Alright. Roll to hit.
Woo.
Roll with advantage.
Woo! Ah, so good!
Oh shit. Natural 18.
Natural 18 to hit.
Yeah.
Roll for damage.
Yeah, 8.
It's adorable.
Thank you.
And the thing is disintegrated.
Nope.
No, the one I.
Roll an arcana check, even though you're not really part.
Nope.
Nine?
Not even adding any.
You can't. Okay. It's pretty obvious because you watched it happen that his gust of wind put out the fire temporarily. You can see it sparking back to life, but without the fire, it kind of just goes docile for a second. It's kind of like you pulled out, you like unplugged it for a bit. It's slowly booting itself back up. That kind of thing.
Fucking Windows updates. Well done.
You're welcome.
Okay, I decided the gust of wind bans a being
down the lane. Hey, I did that for you, motherfucker.
Gust of wind, crawl.
Roll!
Just keep rolling.
Alright, Jay-Z.
Yeah.
Or Hadrian, I should say.
Hadrian!
Go Hadrian? I'm not close enough to really do anything, so I'm just going to move as close as I can. My movement is 30.
To that one?
Correct.
You want the player?
As close as I can, it won't matter.
Well, I mean, you can use your action to dash. You don't have a 30.
Well,
I mean, you can't do anything.
But I can also, take a ready to action. Which I'm going to do, so if he approaches me, I'm just going to attack.
Yep, you get an attack of opportunity when it comes.
So that is what I am going to do.
Yeah.
You taking an attack stance or defensive stance?
Defense.
Okay. So then you... Here's what I'm going to say. When it comes to taking a ready action, it depends on what you say your ready action is going to be. If your ready action is to attack, you'll get an attack of opportunity when it comes close.
Okay.
If you're taking a defensive stance, it will get disadvantage on its next attack roll against you because you're prepared for the attack.
Okay,
does that make sense? Do you still want to go with defensive?
Yes.
Okay.
That actually is an action
book. Shut your fucking mouth. I don't care.
Take away experience.
Motherfucker. Mm-hmm. It's your turn.
We'll go behind sub-10.
Okay.
Yelling with my voice.
How far is your
get? Just say that shit.
Should be 30. Yes.
So here?
Yeah.
Too bad it wasn't Adrian who I pushed because you basically get a free movement with that gust of wind. I will be using it that way a lot more.
Yeah.
Why do you think I designed the hookshot? It has the capability to bridge a 60-foot gap.
I like
of either he's just like, come to me or I'll come to you without having to use movement. I designed items for you guys, specifically. The only thing I didn't is I designed arrows thinking she, when she said she was going to do rogue, was she was going to do archery as well, but...
I do have a shortbow.
Right, I mean...
I want a mini crossbow.
Fairy
fire on the second guy. Yes. And it's a 20-foot cube? Yes.
20-foot cube?
Yeah, so I assume it's the first guy.
I'm going to assume that you're going to place it in a way where it hits both of them?
Yes. If I can't hit the third guy, then yeah.
Well, you can't hit all three of them.
Sure.
Yeah, 5, 10, 15, 20. So do you want to put it on the edge?
Wait. No, the center point is going to be that base. The
this guy?
Flail, yes.
Okay.
Flail!
Oh, hey. Hey, what do you know? Fairy, fairy fire is
any
not.
Attack rolls against the creature has all
fairy fire. Yeah, it's not.
It's fine.
Ooh, they're all purple.
God. Okay, so that's what it does. It just gives them all.
It gives attack rolls advantage.
Okay.
Yep. Fairy fire.
Anything else? As he's going to fight the one that's.
Because I know you can't hit shit. That was sarcastic.
We all pick
the greatest, greatest thing that has ever happened.
Hey, have you that's ever rolled a nat 20 on Bud?
No.
I'm not ready to kill L.
Okay. Are you done there?
Yes.
Varys, okay. L, your turn.
Oh, yeah, I finally get to go. I'm going to go up to the doorway.
Hide.
Why would I hide?
Peace!
And then I'm going to chill touch on the very, very far one by the table. Because I have 120 range on that.
That is a ridiculous range.
It is.
For something
ridiculous.
Called chill touch?
Yeah. Yeah.
You think it's
well,
a,
because it's a skeletal
hand. Yeah, it's just like.
Oh, that's awesome.
So I do get advantage on this because of the fairy fire, right?
Yep.
It's an attack roll.
Fairy fire!
She's like, you're gonna
that's what Nestle does in Smash
Brothers. That would be a 22 to hit.
Okay, that's a hit.
Sweet.
Riggedy roll for diggity damage.
Which is necrotic damage. Not 6 points.
18
dumb. Dude!
Well, I mean, that could be important. Necrotic, you can't kill that.
Motherfucker. Cool, thanks for giving me ideas.
I'm not using that next spell. Woodwall. I cast woodwall.
Okay, I fucked that up. Okay. Oh. I just did one of the wrong ones first, so.
Oh.
Yeah, roll with it.
Yeah.
It's a cube and it should be a circle.
No. Which one? Oh, I didn't. Okay, good. I didn't make a mistake. I couldn't remember which one I did move. Okay.
Do I get my attack of opportunity?
Oh, no, you took a defensive, so it has disadvantage on roll, so.
I'm waiting.
So.
So I didn't hit his guy. No, he hit his shit. I did a lot of that last session.
Does a 13 hit?
No.
That should have been natural 20.
I love a natural 20.
Okay.
I like how so far most of the things that like other members have done has just made these guys' lives really hard.
Hey, this is what is referred to as teamwork. This is what our big game fails at doing.
Yeah.
Hey.
Putting effort into making sure that everybody has.
I am a support character in that game.
I'm a hero.
My favorite is still looking back on that game where it was like just a small group of us dealing with like orcs after we left the camp. Not realizing that the big guy was going to show up, and I'm like, I'll just let everybody who wants to use their area of effect, super powerful spells, and you all burn through your spell slots, and it's like, oh, one of the main big bad guys shows up now, and everybody's like, we just burned all of our spells to do fun, like, area of effect spells. That was hilarious.
Just fuck!
Which one was that again? That was the tower's dad that showed up out of nowhere, right?
Yeah, he was a good guy.
No, that was when he was a bad guy.
Oh, when he was
yeah,
a bad
guy. He was an awful guy.
Yeah.
That was so cool.
And nobody.
Well, we got that target.
Yes, okay.
I'm sorry.
Anyways.
I'm just getting a little out of there. Yeah.
Yeah,
and he
okay, now it's this guy's turn.
That was a great moment.
Okay. Motherfucker. Was a 13 hit?
Yes.
Oh, shit.
Mercy.
You have great AC, by the way.
No. I'm a dude in a wheelchair wearing robes. What do you expect?
So, since you're lower,
seven damage. Okay, your turn.
Well, the guy right in front of me, I need my cantrip Ray of Frost on him.
Okay.
Make a ranged spell attack against the target.
It's a cantrip?
It's a cantrip, yes.
You basically, at this point, you feel a hand on your shoulder as he says, put a lot more faith in your cantrips. Just so you know, every time you use a cantrip, it is increased by a spell power. Forever.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Treat every cantrip as it is a level one spell now, not just a cantrip. So if it has increased damage because it's a because you use a spell slot.
You usually don't get that.
No, it's
like
usually on your
fifth level.
That's fine.
Yeah, at fifth level.
Let's see what you're going to go. Literally, your crown is assisting you significantly.
Yeah, you're
right.
So here, I'll read out what the card says. The spells, like, at higher levels, the spell's damage increases by 1d8 when you reach 5th level, 2d8,
yeah.
Okay.
11th level, so on.
Then you do that.
So pretend like you are at 5th level.
It basically, it's boosting every single cantrip of yours by its next, like, adding another die of the same stuff.
Okay!
Yeah, so
5th,
11th, and 17th.
I could.
So if it's a 1d, if it's a 1d8, it's now 2d8. If it's a...
All right, well, I'm going to go for it here. And that's going to be a 17 to hit him.
Yep.
Advantage? Yeah. Oh, with advantage?
Yeah.
21. Natural one. Okay, so Ray of Frost, so 2d8 cold damage, and its speed is reduced by 10 feet until the start of your next turn. I don't have my spell attack to this, do I?
No, I don't.
It's 9 cold damage.
No,
it's just attack.
Yeah.
Oh, it's an attack.
I was just
spell casting modifier?
It's all dependent on the spell, but no.
You said 9?
Yeah, 9. Hold an 8 or 1.
It's 2
So, what was the other effect?
And also, his speed is reduced by 10 feet until the start of my next turn.
Okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, that was cold damage to him, so I don't know if that does anything extra to him.
Nope.
Damn it. I need a bucket of water.
Do you pond your water?
Yeah, I'm really happy with that.
Do you have to drink water?
No. Well, I mean, I would.
No, I don't think I could conjure.
Okay. As this one finally sparks, like slowly sparks back to life and stands back up, it's taking a second to, like, kind of get its bearings.
Oh, that's right.
So it does. What?
No, I'm just joking.
Right, pretty much. So, yeah, it doesn't have a turn this turn. It just, like, pretty much spent those few seconds to...
And just to clarify, that when I did that gust of wind, that is a concentration, but I dropped it when I did Raven Field.
I figured.
I just wanted to clarify because I did not.
That's right. I don't know who would use gust of wind constantly.
Well, I mean, I could. I could keep...
Right, right.
Well, I mean, if you're trying to, like, make a wheel...
Sail.
Well, a sail, but I was thinking a windmill.
Cool,
like,
we have a plan for a bucket.
Like, windmills, you're like...
So you're stuck in the middle of the
part of the company.
Okay.
So what level was... You used a cantrip?
That was a cantrip. That Ray of Frost was a cantrip.
When you use a cantrip, now just let me know it's a level one.
Okay, it's level one. Okay. Is that using one of my spell slots?
Nope.
Okay, that's what
I just want to treat it as a level one.
I was going to say, don't make me use my spell slots, because that would suck.
No.
It's
no.
Like, hey.
No, that's fine. Not.
Okay, cool. How far is this guy?
He is 45. Okay, roll the hit.
16.
Miss.
Oh, wait, that's actually 18.
Oh, okay.
I forgot I have a plus 2 in my range.
Gotcha. Yep, hit.
Never mind. Sorry, I'm looking up, I'm just realizing what I did with a lot of my stuff. My dexterity mod is a plus 4. And proficiency is
like,
oh yeah, so that is 18.
So you hit.
So hit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Roll.
Got this tonight. As I roll 14.
For damage?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. So which one is that? 14?
Yep.
Just for fun. Okay. Yeah. The hit is hard enough to push it back 5 feet. It's what I call the significant damage modifier that I made up for myself. I like the idea that if you do a considerable amount of damage to something, it actually has an effect on it. Okay. Hadrian.
Since he missed his attack, I'm just going to come straight at him with both my weapons.
Okay. Roll the hit.
Give him the chair.
Just, yeah. Give him the chair!
Give him the chair!
19.
Hit. Roll damage.
15.
15 damage overall?
Yep.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Venus. Venisect!
Venisect!
That's not amazing, but that's all I can think of.
Thank you.
I'm gonna use Chill Touch on the one that just rebooted himself.
Chill Touch? Awesome!
That poor bastard is just like, ugh.
Healing
by I'm back!
He's not even gonna have a chance to do shit.
He feels weak because he's got the Raven Fever hit on.
He's just like, dude, I'm hungover.
Okay.
26? That's, yeah.
Just
thank you, Internet Explorer.
That's
6 damage, and he has disadvantage on attack rolls. It's all my attack rolls.
He has disadvantage? He does have disadvantage.
6 damage?
6 damage. And we get advantage.
This guy's gonna be like,
I think we should just let him live at this point. He's already suffered enough.
It's been a bad day.
I mean, I was trying to get a pet.
I'm taking junk.
Only not soon.
Come on, Jim.
All right.
My folk.
L.
Who?
Yeah, exactly. I'm gonna chill touch again. I'm gonna do it. Dude that's close to me ish.
The one that's right next to.
This one.
That one, okay.
Yeah.
So nobody gets advantage on anything.
I thought I had advantage on it.
I was saying because you're using Chill Touch as well. None of them get advantage on it.
Okay, that's much better. Why did you time out? It was a plus 4, wasn't it?
We're memorizing other stats.
I can't remember. It is a plus 4. Okay, so yeah, that's 18 to hit.
Yep, hit.
Don't steal my, like, it's not spell stuff.
I can't cast spell
stuff. It's my turn!
And that's natural 8 of my D8.
Okay. So 8 damage overall.
And it's necrotic again.
That's good.
Okay,
is that it? Does a 16 hit, Hadrian?
Yes.
Okay. Six damage. Okay, and who is that? Oh, it's that one. Okay. So if you do, oh, never mind. It actually has not left combat with you, so you don't get a.
Well, the fairy fire just hits him with it when it's cast. He's still affected by it. It's like if glitter falls on them, and now they have glitter on them.
They're glittery!
So what does that do again? Just out of curiosity.
They can't hide, they can't turn invisible, and we have advantage against them.
Okay.
But
so
it sticks with them even when they're outside.
So you have advantage on hits against it?
Yes.
Okay. Just making sure. Does a...
Gotcha.
12 hit.
Okay.
Okay, cool. C'est pété.
Sure.
I didn't do that. I knew exactly what I was going to do. I had probably 6 out of it. I knew, but stupid. I'm gonna quickly turn to the guy who just went behind us and do the Ray of Frost again right at
him.
Okay. Ready, Saul.
We have advantage on him.
We have advantage on
him. Okay, I'll take that first roll. That's going to be.
Is this a range? Range attacks are a disadvantage. If it's N 5 feet, it's a disadvantage.
Oh, that's true.
So this is a standard roll for me.
What'd you get?
On my first roll, or
yeah.
Then it's 19.
Okay, still hit.
Yeah, fine.
I just wanted to.
Yeah.
Sure that's
so. Yeah.
I wasn't sure if that rule still applied for magic as well.
As far as I know, any range.
Because you're still kind of.
drawing yet. Gotcha.
Have a
book. How do you not have a book?
Another 9. 8 and a 1 again. Different dice this time.
This is clearly my book. How I know? First off, these are here. And second, this one's falling
apart. And his speed is reducing it by 10 feet. I don't know if that. Does that stack?
What?
The speed reducing? Does that stack?
No.
Okay.
If it did, that'd be broken.
Well, it would be really broken.
Well,
so,
I mean,
and now you can't move because you're really fucking cold, man.
I was gonna say, how long does the
produce
speed last?
Oh, by the start of your next turn.
So
just continue.
Yeah,
so
it just
continues.
It keeps going.
Yeah. And I realized I didn't take my 4th cantrip.
So you used another cantrip?
Yeah, that was another lovely
Okay.
Ray of Frost is.
Yep. Make sure you let me know about that shit.
Sorry.
Sorry. Does a 15 hit?
Match?
Okay, so yes. Boop, boop, boop. Ooh, scary, 5 minutes.
Great, Google.
Now this thing has woken up, so. At 10. 15. And he does half damage.
Would you
damage.
Want me
okay.
to begin? Yeah. Specifically state that with spells involving a range attack, you have disadvantage.
Okay, cool, good to know. Does 11 hit, step of 10?
No.
Okay. Nice. All right, Knots.
Just wanted. Oh, shit.
What?
Wait. I knew that was testimony.
It's where I put it.
This guy has, you have advantage on, right?
Yep. Both the enemies over there, you do.
Both of them, yeah.
Plus the one over here.
And these ones have, do we have advantage on them as well or no?
Just him.
I'm trying to get that guy.
Okay.
Wow. If I have 2 10s, that's another 18.
18? Okay, yep.
10.
10 damage? And he just explodes into a pile of cinders.
Double kill. It's a middle home
kill. First one's not your kill.
That one doesn't make any difference. Yeah, it was. It's just exactly what I can do.
Okay.
Okay. So, Hadrian.
I'm going to hit him with the...
Still feel like I'm in the wrong spot in line now. Is it
It's a hit. Roll for damage.
14
damage?
Yep.
How are you swinging?
I was just going to come up with my war hammer and down at the knee with my sword.
Okay. We'll just say you kind of push him off the side a little bit then. That's about it. Okay. Bearish. Yeah.
Hit him with my spear.
You're gonna spear the motherfucker. Huh?
Exactly.
I'm gonna spear the motherfucker.
Eloquently.
Kill the motherfucker.
That's a natural 20.
Nice.
Nice.
Roll for damage.
It's a spear. You don't know what spear's damage is?
It's your weapon. Why don't you figure it out?
One handed or two? One handed.
1d6.
1d6.
Doubled.
Doubled. Six.
Nice.
So 12 plus strength is 2. That's 14 damage.
Wait, did you
crit?
Yeah,
you
did.
14
damage. As you poke all the way through him, and he bursts into a pile of embers.
Oh, bitch.
Are you done then?
That's it.
All right, L.
So we only have that last guy left?
Nope.
Oh, so there are some.
Okay.
Just the fairy fire guy.
Yep.
And I'm gonna touch, do the chill touching thing again. Okay, I got a 17.
That's a match, so hit.
Yay! I don't know if that's more. That is 2 points of necrotic damage.
Ouch!
Mercy. Mercy! Mercy! Does a 13 hit?
Yeah.
Sip a tea.
I have a quick question before I make my attack. Since Varys is right here, and he has a sweet spear, is there any way I could use my Ray of Frost to put it on his spear for like a team attack?
You can do that. What would happen is then the attack would not happen until his turn.
Sure.
And he has to agree to a team up attack.
Varys, team attack.
Sure.
And I cast Ray of Frost on the tip of his spear.
Okay.
You're dead.
What do I do to that? Or we just roll off.
What is the damage for Ray of Frost?
Same thing I've been doing. It'll be 2d8.
So add 2d8 to your spear attack.
2d8 cold to your spear.
So are they gingerly touching?
He's gingerly touching my tip.
Yes.
Wait, the tip of his wand.
Okay.
So they're touching tips.
I just pictured the cold just going.
Yeah. Sure, that's cool.
Does a 12 hit?
It matches.
Okay.
Ooh, I have a higher.
Ooh, that's rough. That is rough.
Wait, which one is this? This is the one in front of me? This is the guy that sells Raven Gibbleman on.
Yep, okay. Cool, good to know.
Yeah.
So.
So it's half damage.
If it's strength.
If it's a strength.
Okay,
cool. I'm really happy I fucking did that.
Okay.
My leg!
Not.
Okay, cool.
And that's just what I was doing.
Oh, I'm going to. He has advantage. Does this one still have advantage?
Advantage?
Yeah, do we still have advantage?
No.
On that one?
No. We want in the box right now.
The only one in the box.
Do I want to be nice, or do I want to be an asshole?
I don't know.
What would your character do?
Yeah, what would your character do?
I'm gonna go for that guy.
Okay.
Right in front of Sepetan. Naturally,
D. Nice. Roll for damage.
14.
What was it? 14. I'm an asshole.
That is just, that's like exactly how much damage you have to.
Yes!
It's alright, we can still do this. There goes my achievement.
Did you see that?
Yes.
If you get an attack. Spears of Chrome.
Wait.
Ah!
Jay just got a natural 20 in Lineage's College. Do you know?
It's just the first person.
How are we doing this?
Achievements are not stackable. Sorry.
They're not stackable. Well, that wouldn't be stackable.
What's up?
What's up? So, gents. Hadrian.
I might come down and just try to smash both weapons on his head.
Okay.
Hi-yah!
16.
Miss.
Ooh, do this.
Okay, it is your turn.
I'm gonna walk forward so I'm within 20 feet and then throw my spear.
5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. You can actually just straight hit him at that point.
I'd rather throw.
Okay.
I'd rather throw.
Better dexterity than I do strength.
I wanna shoot the spear at each other.
Yeah, Atlas will go out of that. Hang on.
No! No!
Yes!
No. 8. You know it's a miss!
I love the build up too. No! Wait!
It was not a 1, it was a 2.
8.
Well done, Rob. I like how that 8's gonna be like, yeah, that'll be
nice. Okay.
Our first opportunity.
So you throw the spear and it goes straight over the thing's head.
Yeah, you still lost your weapon.
Oh, yeah!
I
kind of
see a deal like this is gonna be so cool in slow motion. You see yourself throwing the spear.
I'm just like, great with weapons. I'm like watching him run over there. I'm just kind of like.
Like, why did I
expect it too much?
All right, El.
Oh,
it's
you
a second.
Do it.
Yeah, I'll throw another,
ghost.
Just kill
him.
We got more important things to do.
I do not have advantage
on
this guy.
Nope. Just disadvantage. Okay. Go,
dude. Oh, shit. That's a miss.
Okay. It's
14.
Yeah, it's a miss.
So, yeah, I'm not
going to
do anything.
There
you
go.
I left him for
you. Motherfucker.
You just threw a spear
at
my head!
Attack of opportunity there, gents.
Yes.
Go ahead.
Yes. You're just gonna let it hit me?
Thanks for the help.
I tried!
He's like,
nice toss!
Does a mildly terrifying 8 hit you too?
Oh, no.
I thought you were gonna say yes with the way you did that.
Right?
I was gonna be like, holy shit.
Yeah, see,
does
it's
he
continuous.
Throw his spear over his head?
Shut up!
Considering it's a Warhammer, he's just like...
Everybody gets one.
So, step a 10.
I'm gonna, and I'm assuming I'm still facing that way, I'm gonna like scroll backwards real quick to get line of sight on the guy, and then I'm gonna once again cast Ray of Frost at him.
Okay. So another Ray of Frost.
Yep. And then that's going to be a 18.
Hit.
Did you switch yourself to knots in line of sight?
It's alright, you can just shoot over his head. He's 10 frost damage.
No, I'm just gonna go.
And it.
Boom! Got it!
As you freeze it solid and it crumbles into a pile of icy business. As you kill the last one, anything in the room that was on fire immediately goes out.
Oh, awesome.
Whew.
Okay. Now I'm gonna cover the room.
Okay.
That's good. Well, we did it.
How you doing, old man?
Do I see anything shiny and valuable in the room?
I was just about to say, don't even bother asking because everything they were turned to fucking ash and dust.
What about the animals?
Ash
they
and dust.
On fire.
That's perfect. Everybody getting 450 experience.
450.
I don't even need the math.
What's next level at?
450.
Next level is 6,650.
4,450. 5,250. Mm-hmm.
Because of that nice, nice thing.
So as the fires go out, it is dead silent in the room now. As even Gaius walks in, he goes, oh, lovely, lovely. Thank you all. I was trying to think of a way that I can repay you. Oh, I don't really have much aside from gold.
Gold is totally fine, I'll take it. I'll take the hit and take it.
Oh.
It's fine, guys.
All right. All I can do is give each of you 1,000. That's all I have on me. I hope
that's wonderful.
You know,
okay.
Think of it as a favor.
And can we use this room? What for?
Use it for what?
We have a free tavern that we can stay in. Whatever.
But this way, we've got a beholder watching our back.
You can't see into this room.
Exactly.
Well, I could. Probably
figure out
how to
everything
okay.
On the outside of the room.
As you say that, you look back at the door and all you see is this big eye in the doorway. It's like...
Can he cast minor illusion to the giant middle finger?
No.
There's only one bedroom.
I'm not sharing a bed with all of you.
I'm not sharing a bed either.
I'll take my gold, please. Thank you.
So you each get 1,000 gold.
Did you all want a room here? I mean, nobody else is using this one. It is a little uncozy now that it's charred completely, and even the one bed is destroyed. But you're welcome to use it whenever you want.
I would like to study this enchantment, see if I can maybe drop it. It'd be fun.
Okay.
When we get back from our
first endeavor,
of course. But I would like to.
Yes, we have to go help children now.
To the orphanage.
Oh, yes, that's right, the orphanage.
Everybody make a perception check.
As I go, I like, get some ash off of me.
Christ!
I'm going to take it because...
19.
What'd you get? So yours was highest?
19!
You hear, coming from the area over by the cages, a very faint crying.
The fuck?
Legit. The way he's just like, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Sweet. Now that you're next to me, how are you doing? Don't care. We're going to go investigate the cage real quick.
Okay.
While they're doing that, I'm just going to roll around the room and just kind of see if I can study what kind of, like, just kind of get an idea of what this enchantment
is. Okay, do an investigation check.
Get over here too. We're gonna go investigate.
Bang.
Yeah, I want to go see the animals in the cages.
Okay.
I want to identify the crime.
All right, I'll let you know in a second.
Yeah, no,
so, each of you who's looking for what was crying, make an investigation check. Those of you who did not already.
17.
Same thing. I got fucking 8.
So Hadrian finds it first. Behind many of the other cages, you do find a very small cage. And inside it, you do see this small humanoid form kind of cowering at the back of the cage and crying.
Is the cage locked, or can I just open the cage? Or?
The cage is locked. We'll just say that. It basically has a small enough style of lock where, imagine it's like how you would lock a guinea pig in. It can't get out, but you can just as easily just fucking open it from the outside.
I was gonna say, wait, I can lock it. I don't need lock
it. No. I'm gonna open the cage.
Okay, so you open the cage and little form just like pushes over to the edge even.
I found it too.
Eventually, yes. Once he found it, he like.
Can I try to identify what it is?
Yeah, go on.
What I roll for?
Just roll a hit nature.
19.
You do see a small, let me decide here really quick. Oh, I'm just trying to. No, I'm just trying to decide.
It's a baby
trash.
No, that thing would not be small. We would fill this room. A baby trash would fill this room.
We'll just stick with the basic color. A small green pixie. That's the reason why I didn't want to go with green.
Nah, I don't care. Before you open the cage, wait a sec. Can you speak common?
Yeah.
Groovy. Now, what's your name?
And she just kind of like slowly turns around and looks over at you guys. My name is Neely.
Neely.
What?
This
is dumb, I'm out. Fuck you guys, nobody cares. Neely, N-E-E-L-Y.
What are you doing here?
The bad man, he caught me outside and wanted to do things. Okay, I realize how bad that sounded, I'm sorry.
Experiment,
we got
it. It's fine, he's dead, he blew himself up.
I'm sure she saw it.
Would you like to come with us?
It was terrible, but also kind of fun to watch.
What, him blow up?
Yes.
Did him blow up?
Yeah.
You asked her if she wants to come with you?
I did.
You want me to come with you?
Well, it's got to be better than staying here.
How big is the pixie?
It's tiny.
She's giving.
Oh, yeah. Little pixies are tiny pictures.
She's a tiny fae.
They're not there, shut up.
I'll come with you.
Cool.
As she gets over to the edge of the cage, not quite getting out yet, she's like, I will serve anyone who wants to be my master. Shut up.
I'm sorry, I'm sorry.
This is turning into the beginning of a bad BDSM book, okay?
Why do you need a master?
It's just kind of what us Fae do. We all, those of us in the Fae Lands, we all serve one of the two queens, and I'm not in the Fae Lands anymore, so I need someone to basically watch over me and for me to, for lack of a better term, serve.
How about you just come and be a companion and watch over you anyways?
Well,
to serve anybody.
What can you do?
I can do a couple of things. I can do some magic. Just a couple simple things. But I can help out any way you want me to.
I'm gonna bring her.
Okay.
The pixie.
All right, so the important thing is, I guess since someone wants to attack Ron, I'm not. This is Lurch. Hadrian.
Good to meet you, Lurch Hadrian.
I already like her. This is Elle. That's Wheelbound, and I point to Sepetan.
All you do is you're just like looking around shit like...
Grialos was in here, but he left, I guess. So, enjoy your
Grialos.
And and I let go of your hand, letting you open.
Perfect.
So basically, as she does this, she's just like, she holds out her hands, and this this small green flame appears between them. And she's like, who's accepting?
Alright.
So she just like reaches out, like she's handing it to you.
Touch it.
You don't even have to touch it. By the time your hand gets close, it just leaps to your hand. And just sinks into your hand, and you can feel like a warmth shoot up your arm. Really quick. Yep. So at this point, I will give you the option. Would you like me to hold on to her character sheet?
Yeah.
This is pretty much a new party member.
Then yes, I would like you to.
Okay. She has specific rules and capabilities.
I think I have a creature in that.
No, this is an actual creature.
Yeah.
She's an actual
party
member.
Being I know, but I think I have like stats.
Oh yeah, I have her entire sheet.
Being that we're at 11:20, would we like to take a break with the doggo? We just got done with the battle, and we got a new friend.
Yep, that's fine.
All right.
So, break time. Somebody want to go and touch Nick Michael's balls really quick? So,
and we're back.
Really quick, to cover Neely's capabilities, I can control her if you want, which is fine. I'll control her personality. I don't know if you care specifically about this.
I don't give a shit.
So, after that happens, she like flutters up and just pretty much like lands on your shoulder and just sits there for a bit. And she says, the one thing that you can do is you can actually help make me more powerful in whatever way you want me to be. Shut up. Shut up. I don't know of any nicer way to do this. No, it's really not. I even thought of that, so.
Enjoy your friend. I'm going to go check on the old
guy. Okay. You just have to, okay, to put this easily in a way that I don't have to try to describe in DM or in D&D terms.
Sexual.
Yes, you can share experience with her and she will legitimately level up.
Oh.
Yes. And you can have her focus on a specific style of ability and she can actually learn new abilities.
So like we get from the experience
you gain. Pretty much. You can pretty much just decide like when you gain experience if you're gonna give any to her.
Oh my god! That would be
awesome!
It starts to be
like there's a
floating
grace
behind you. Polymorph into a great sword? Oh, I know she can. I was just saying, how cool would that be?
Well,
but you do have the decision whether or not to have her focus on offensive capabilities or defensive capabilities.
Would that any of that include
it can, yeah. Basically, you tell her like what you want her to focus on, and she can focus on it. When she levels
Druid
up.
Crash. Put it all towards Druid Crash.
Neely, I would love for you to become a healer.
Okay. I can do that. Alrighty. That's a thing now.
Ready to go out to the adventures?
Oh, yes. I'm excited. Little fairy glass.
Little fairy. I really am. Picturing.
Right. We should change the color.
No.
Well, it's funny because if you look at the picture in the fucking book, like it shows.
It's not Julia Roberts, is it?
No.
The one I have is Amy Brown.
Oh. No. Like the picture in the book is actually pretty cool.
It is.
Which is why I was like, I like keeping her green.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, she's hot.
Yeah. Right.
That's how I was made.
That's what she looks like.
Crayon.
Yeah. Her basically with red hair.
Crayon. Yes.
So literally that picture.
Yeah.
So poison ivy, got it.
Yeah. The poison ivy with wings that's a foot tall.
Tiny little poison ivy. Or,
like 8 inches tall.
Way for your face.
Right. All right, so you were looking around the room?
I was just seeing if I could figure out anything about the enchantment at this moment in time. 16.
The enchantment that's blocking the room, or the enchantment he used for summoning?
That's keeping the beholder out, the thing that's blocking the room.
From what you can make out, there are specific wards carved into the walls. Mm. Like, literally along the stone, that is like a ward specifically towards the beholder.
Can I find out if there's any way to just get rid of like one or all of the wards to allow...
Make an arcana.
That's going to be a 19.
You do know that the only way to dispel this kind of magic would be to, for lack of a better term, destroy what it's inscribed on. You'd have to destroy the room.
And to destroy the whole room?
Yeah, any piece of something that the spell is inscribed on, like these runic shapes, would have to be destroyed and rebuilt.
So I couldn't, like, just...
No, it's literally built into the stone at this point.
Oh. Okay.
So.
Okay.
Anybody else doing anything else? You left.
Just checking on the
open. Okay.
No, I'm towards the door now. I'm heading up.
Okay. So Gaius is kind of just leaning against the wall a bit, like.
Are you gonna be okay?
Yes, as his hands are already starting to heal as he kind of focuses on him. And Junko's basically just floating right above him, just like all eyes on him, making sure he's okay. Just looking like really like concerned about the old guy's safety.
So they clearly have a bond, basically,
for a while. Right, from what you can understand. I'll be fine. That actually worked a lot better than I thought it would. Alright. Alright, well, thank you all for that help. That was interesting. Thankfully, it looks like his experimentation center was destroyed by those things, so don't have to worry about any more sneaking in and, looks like somebody made a new friend.
As he looks over at you and she's just like,
not helping.
I actually did figure a little bit out about the enchantment that's keeping Junko.
Good to see you doing well. Right.
Okay. It seems like the only way that we'd be able to allow him to go back into this section would be if we pretty much put down all the walls.
Oh, yes.
It's pretty difficult.
Well, that's fine. I don't think anyone will be using this room anytime soon, unless one of you wanted to use it for anything in particular, which is fine. I don't mind either way. Considering how long he was operating here, it's fine. We can do without one last room.
Sorry, buddy.
It's all right. All right. Oh, no. Fuck this room.
So you're saying all I gotta do is destroy the walls?
Kidoki. So you're all heading back up?
Yes.
Yep.
Right. Really quick, I wanna do this.
You are the worst beggar ever. Stop looking at me.
Sorry.
You looked down for like a second. Hold on.
So you're all just kind of filing out of the college, I assume?
Yeah, we're heading to the orphanage, right?
How long did it take?
Huh?
How long does it take?
Right, it took like about a half an hour between when you guys got started and walked back and met back up. So it's still like, it's barely midday considering you guys got here like 6 in the morning, so it's like 10 at best.
That's right, it started extremely early.
Again, Hot Wheels is talking.
I'm sorry. Like I said, I thought you all liked my little knowledge, but that's fine.
I like your knowledge.
She just went
I don't know anything about pixies.
Well, I was explaining it to Varys, not you, not.
How do I be a wonderful master to the pixie?
Well, if you really want to know,
I'm not going to touch that one.
According to the
book,
one book that I read, that's Gus. Interesting.
Holy shit, he knows about the birds and bees.
Well, yeah, from what I hear, Big Nuts here paid for a hookerboard.
Your name is now Big Nuts. I prefer Lurch.
You two are hilarious.
I think so, yes.
Sorry.
So,
well, I was saying the only way to really, you know, do that is, well, be nice to her. If you want to be a good master, she'll just do everything you say. I'm pretty sure that's, it's fairly obvious.
She's just a creature built to serve.
That sounds terrible.
Make a perception check. Everybody.
Ah, oh, shit.
Six.
Oh.
Not
perceptible. 15. That's my first.
I'm focused on the
15.
23! Only you notice this. But she
do
seems
I hear her cry?
No.
Good.
She seems legitimately scared of him.
Him?
Yes.
Oh, bitch.
And right before you're about to leave, you actually hear the sound of feet behind you like, Nuts! Wait a second. Oh. As you turn around, Gunst just kinda is running up to you just like out of breath, like, oh. Were you just about to leave?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Well,
I'll catch up.
So as he pulls you aside, he's like, okay.
I'm gonna stealth and follow.
Roll for stealth. Roll for perception.
Oh, God, that was horrible. 11.
20.
Ooh.
Damn it, man!
Boom!
That's 15. I rolled a 3!
I saw it, yes.
Can I ask if
you
following
to
what's
going on? Yeah. As she like floats up.
Her stealth is not as good as mine.
You sure?
She's
on
Casey, she is stealth.
As she
stealth is higher than her, they check.
She calculated her invisibility.
Yep. As she completely disappears. Right.
But she would still roll herself
with
damage.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
She has
weak. What?
She has to beat it. A natural 20. Odds are she could easily beat it.
21.
Oh, fuck yourself.
I hear wings.
So, as Gunn's kind of leads you over, he's like, just grab the car quick. Okay. Anybody who wants to make a perception check?
I was gonna say nobody like on the
other. Right. Yeah. So you both like are standing with your backs to each other.
Natural 20.
Okay.
That's because nobody told me to go away, and I just kept going.
So as he pulls out a weapon that, you know, obviously you kind of get an idea about how it looks, and he pulls back a portion of this part. He goes just. Set it in there. Okay. He closes it back up. Specifically with your nat 20, you don't want to go near this thing because of the last thing you saw when you... Who else got above 15?
Oh, I have a perception.
Perception.
If you saw it.
What was your perception?
Five.
Lovely. You got what? 15. You got a 15? Okay. So as they're over there doing stuff, you do see like, oh, I suppose we should do that.
Well, yeah, and she has detect evil.
On who?
Me
or the weapon?
I'll just do a group search of the party.
You're good. You're shit.
So as she, you don't notice, but she does actually like see you guys doing this. As you set the core into it quick, you know, using the cloth that's inside to set it in there, so you don't have to actually touch it again. He closes it back up and then like basically snaps the thing back into place, and you can actually see like this orangish red energy just shoot through the entirety of the weapon.
Jay. That's so fucking cool.
He goes, okay. So it's kind of a rush job, so it's not as powerful as it could be. Once I spent a little bit more time with it. But it will do for now. And just like you asked, basically all you need to do is grab the stock, and there's a button underneath, so just pull that, and he does it. And when he does it, the barrel actually shoots out another foot and a half, as well as the stock extends further out. And he goes, and then as it does that, like the top flips open, and there's two like really basic, like looking glass style sights.
What? You basically can see all of this.
I saw all of
you're seeing all of this, but at the same time you are legitimately terrified because you know what this thing is and you know what it showed. So you're just like, part of you is like, why am I even looking at this?
We should not be carrying this around.
Are you buying
this?
Yeah. You saw her, you didn't do anything about it.
I'm just letting this happen.
And Guns is like, don't worry, it's safe. Once it's inside here, it's fine.
Don't think it's very safe.
Just don't touch it.
Do you trust me?
Do you want the real answer?
Yes.
Or do you want the one that's going to make you feel better?
Well, I already know what the real answer is.
Exactly! Why did you fucking ask?
See, it's perfectly safe. And he cocks it and goes... As he cocks it, you actually see the light like explode from where the core is throughout the gun again.
I assume that she
doesn't. Right. So, basically, you have an invective that turns into an icebreaker.
That's a fucking goal!
We're at 7 just for tonight.
We just got started.
Well, that thing also adds an extra +2 to hit no matter what form it's in. Don't forget to write that on there. As you're halfway over there, she comes over and sits on your shoulder and she just goes, he's got a new weapon. And it's really powerful. And it's actually really dangerous.
Oh. It's incredibly fucking dangerous!
He's on our side, right?
I hope so.
Okay, good.
Just know that having this will help solve a lot of problems. A lot of problems.
Dude, it's still freaky as fuck.
Groovy.
Matt, what do you got there?
Not good. No,
that's the actual name too.
What? Core. Well, that's what's in it. Just so you know which core weapon that is. You can call it the fuck you want to call it. I don't give a shit.
You should call it that. So fucking cool.
Versus that.
I was just gonna say call it the Invector.
The worst news.
Terrifying news.
Fuck this shit news.
Right.
Yeah, I'm doping the fuck out. I'm gone.
Okay. And Guns is like, again, let all your friends know about the other stuff I can build if any of them wants or any of them is interested in it.
Yeah,
I'm
going to
You can help build anything you need, really. As long as you have the coin.
At this point, he's relaying the items that he has the capability of building right now. I'll just go over them one more time really quick. He has the ability to build an arm-mounted drill, an antimatter rifle, a hookshot, an elemental grenades of any element you want, an item called the Mage Mite, which is a small hovering mechanized machine that can fire any style of cantrip you want, or any spell in general as long as you spend it on it, indefinitely, as its own movement and capability. And also creating a refraction robe, which is capable of deflecting any amount of damage, period, with a certain amount of charges. Also has explosive / flashbang arrows, and the multi-blade weapon.
That robe. How do I get that?
Oh, that's actually a really, really difficult one. But basically, what I need to do is I need to sew together a metal called adamantine with crystalline particles in it. And what it does is that the way it's hinged along the inside of the clothing when you decide to use a charge of its capability is that the metal and crystal would reflect in a way where it would catch and absorb any style of damage and knock it away, including even like piercing and blunt damage. Yeah, so I would need roughly 20 ingots of adamantine and 20 crystal pieces.
So I have to get this for you?
Yes. And it would roughly cost about 10 grand to make.
Everything I want costs so much money.
You're rich.
Never said I was rich.
You're noble. Shut up.
That floating mage might?
The mage might, yes. That requires about 20 pieces of mithril and one full-size diamond. And that would only cost about 7,500 to make. And that can be programmed with any style of spell, but it has to be one you know, and once it's installed, it cannot be replaced. 7,500. The blade is actually pretty easy. The blade only requires 10 pieces of steel and around 5 pieces of wood, and that will really only cost about 500 gold. And then you just have to tell me what kind of weapon you want it to turn into.
Well,
my word, can I go punch a sealed door?
No. This is not Minecraft, motherfucker! Basically, after the game, let me know if you're interested in any of this shit, and I can get you what is required for it. Like a list of what is required for it.
Alright, let's go.
So as you all file out of the Mages College, passing across the front and whatnot, over the teleportation circle, out of nowhere you do hear the voice, "Alright, everybody take care of yourselves. Don't be causing no trouble. All right?
All right.
All right? All right.
Bye.
Goes double for you. I mean you. Wait. All you. Whatever. Have a good day." And he just kind of disappears again.
All right. I like it.
Okay, so the only person who has basic legitimate knowledge of the orphanage is up, or where it would possibly be. She's the only person who's been in that particular part of the city.
Should we all touch your nose? Is that going to help?
Not that J.
No,
that J.
We all need to do the
touching
notes.
Yes.
I have to double check. I don't know
how to do it. I'm going to ask Neely if she can do any tricks.
What do you mean by tricks?
She can do magic.
I like your friend. I'm going to walk a little bit.
You like
to
talk over there?
No.
Huh? Okay.
I'm intimidated by her kind of duty.
It does require a bonus action in battle to switch between style of weapon.
Well,
I don't write it down, but if I remember, it was in the housing district,
yep.
Northern area.
Yep.
Okay, so I'm gonna head in that direction, and you know,
following.
Yeah.
Okay, so as you follow L, she takes you first to the west, out of the Mages College area, through the High Garden area, back down south to basically the main market district where you guys are all accustomed to, and then again to the east. This is basically the direction right between, or right out. Kind of, yes. The way you understand the city works, it's actually built into like different portions of a cliff. So the bottom is actually down here, and as you go up to like High Garden, it actually is elevated. So from the Mages College, if you want, you could probably go to the edge and look down on the housing district.
So you just like,
not quite. There's a wall there.
Not that we could parachute in. Right?
Right. I got this. So as you enter the housing district, everybody make a perception check quick.
Natural 20.
No, not
I think you really do.
I got 10. Okay. 15.
What?
23.
What was that?
15.
15? Sounded like you said 50 first. I'm like,
Fucking no.
10. 1-5.
1-5. Okay, so you immediately notice the fact that a lot of these houses are, some of them are just, you know, decent. Some of them are okay. Some of them are distinctly disgusting. This is basically where the townspeople live. Everything from merchants to just the common folk who either, you can tell some of them are people who are indentured servants to the upper class, as well as people who work in the palace up on the top, Madridosa's palace. And there is other houses which are just, you know, decently nice houses, different styles of townhomes, little shacks, blah, blah, blah. You can also hear like the sound of children playing off to your left as you walk in here. You can tell there is a park. Basically, from where you guys are walking in, you're walking in through here, and you're heading to here, from what Elle has told you. All these are just different houses and whatnot. Okay? So as you guys are walking, like I said, by about this point, it's roughly midday at the worst. You go all the way down to the end of the street where there's more houses and take a left, and as you do notice it get like a little bit more dingy as you do come across this large stone building that's pretty much built right up against the cliff sides. This building is not in good shape, and up until the point where even like the nameplate for the orphanage itself is like falling apart. Like, you can't even tell the name of this orphanage because it's in that bad of shape.
It's in that bad of shape?
Yes.
Mending.
Okay, so
thank
you
God
fix this out.
Here.
Right. Perfect.
We can solve all the world's problems.
I suppose I forgot to do something, but... All right, we'll just say he's catching up now. So, as you guys are walking... Talmud kind of catches up. He's going to be waiting for you in like the... He's going to be waiting in the market district, but... So he's just like, how did it all go?
Great.
You guys get all the answers you needed?
You got your friend?
Fun.
Servant.
Look at her. She's beautiful.
Servant. Wait, she's spiritually bonded to you now?
There's the choir.
That's kind of what lower level pixies do. They basically, if they are not promised to basically work in someone's service, like the queen, they can devote their powers to anyone else. They'll be faithful. In all honesty, most people have used them for slaves in the past and all kinds of shit like that, but they can be very useful allies. And she's just sitting with a big smile on her face, like... So, I noticed you guys are heading towards the orphanage. Is that your next plan of attack, per se?
Yep.
Excellent. Well, I'll join you for this. Sorry I wasn't able to join you for the... Mages College. Yes. What? You're leaving how soon? Oh, Christ. Okay. So, as you guys walk up to the orphanage, what are you going to do? What the fuck? What did I do with all that shit?
This orphanage is in terrible shape.
It is in terrible shape.
Is there like a window or something that I can peek in?
You can try.
You can try to see her from there.
Okay, I'm gonna like try to find a window.
Okay.
And I'm gonna like peek a little
bit. So as you look around, there are windows on the front. As you peek inside, make a quick perception check. That went well. So as you look inside, you do have dark vision, correct?
Yes, I have dark vision.
Okay. You can see inside, you do see people milling around. You see kids just kind of dressed in pretty nasty looking rags and whatnot, and a few like caretakers. It just looks like a normal orphanage despite being in just kind of piss poor shape.
There's some depressed kids, and I'm gonna go in.
Okay. Everybody going in?
Following.
Everybody goes in.
So I presume Hadrian is not following? No. Okay.
I guess we'll see you later.
Yeah, we're gonna go try to figure out some more about our intent.
Okay.
This is more as
the
I didn't know that was so important.
Top of
the priority
list
there.
You know, these kids are on top of the priority list.
And
without going in, we'll see how
right, so you're putting the ruby completely aside and helping children to find out more about your friend.
No, I'm putting my IRL bedtime.
You getting sleep is more important than children.
Oh!
The fake book, yes!
Hey!
That's me, damn it! Sleep good tonight, asshole!
Why can't you be nice?
Yeah! Better world and shit.
Would you all go and sit on set and roll off the cliff?
Ooh, harsh.
Out loud. That sounds like a horrible idea.
You believe you just said that to yourself his head?
What a dick.
Okay. Yeah, why can't you be nice?
Yeah, sit and relax.
So Hadrian speaks up and says, I'm gonna stay outside here and case the area, make sure there's no one of these little bird folk. Hanging around, you know, vain attempt to seem useful, even though you're not going to be here because your vagina hurts.
That's definitely a good idea.
He's arguing. Yeah. Hey.
Okay.
That doesn't happen very often. Gotta make the most of it.
What? Okay, so as you all. You just walking in?
Just walking in!
Okay. So as you walk in, a very, very gaunt, very underfed woman walks up and goes, hello, what can I do for you?
L, take one.
Thanks, I'm already ahead of you.
He says from the back of the group, L, take one!
I was gonna say, I picture him like going into this building and she just walks in and he just goes right to the door and just
dun, 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 dun.
Shotgun.
Breach! Everything looks good.
He's just cocking it for fun. Just for the sake of adding another counter, that thing doesn't use ammo.
Oh.
That's so fucking cool!
So how would I, it's just charged then?
This pretty much.
You dick.
Yeah, right, if you're gonna want, you're gonna fucking blow your own legs off.
It's okay, I got 17 to carry me up.
Oh, don't worry, there's different effects specifically. For if he misfires. The weapon cannot be damaged. But it can do other things when it misfires.
It's okay, I'll just toss the gun to set the tan whenever it misfires.
No.
Hop, Tindle.
Yeah.
Set the tan, there's it. Blows up.
Okay.
Okay. Hello, madam. We're here to inspect your orphanage, make sure the kids are all safe, and if you're going
on. Make a persuasion check. You're here to inspect the orphanage?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I heard there's been a string of kidnappings going around. I want to make sure it's safe in the little area.
Oh, really? Okay.
Don't want to panic them. Just them in there for kids.
You just rolled in playing with them.
Who wants to ride the train?
Okay.
I'm
trying to get some
soap.
Oh, shut up! Put it away! I could just see, like, Knots using that as, like, an intimidation effect. What, you want to fight?
Man.
Okay, no. Okay. Alright, what did you want to look at? Or did you want a tour or something?
Yes, show us
a
tour.
Okay. I'm gonna show the kids I light my hand on fire.
Oh, yay!
I don't know what
that is. One skill.
Okay, so you are just. Right. And, there's two people like that as you walk down there. There are these three other gentlemen who are basically arranging boxes and unloading food into, like, the underground areas, tons of shelves set up. It is just a dirt floor. Pretty much a root cellar is what this is. In the back, you do see kids, like, tidying, like, these four kids tidying up boxes and whatnot. They seem to be kind of just, like, pissy about it. That kind of thing. Like, they got in trouble, obviously, and they're down here now just, like, cleaning up. There are a couple of basically only candles lit at this point. So it's kind of dim in here and whatnot. Right, because our good is a spirit, so. Exactly. So you can all see why, but. Yeah, the kids that you do see are still just dressed in rags and whatnot. And, so as you kind of just look around, you guys are like, well, I hope this piques your curiosity, your, you know, Christian curiosity. Were you guys looking for anything in particular?
Anything strange.
Define strange.
You want to help me describe this one? Strange bird-like people.
Man in the dress. Well, no.
What?
That one is the most evil one that would be very strange.
No, dress.
Yeah, great big bushy beard. A little more psychotic than some people in the world.
What? Okay.
Don't worry. We're just.
Yes. What does this have to do with the orphanage?
We have given something.
Is there, is there anyone that is, I guess, that kind of would stand out, like they...
Anybody new?
Yeah.
No, not at all, honestly. This is just business as usual. I really don't quite know what Yellow has to do with anything with
Rose. Oh, really?
Thanks, thank
you. What?
Oh, shit.
I wish I was there.
22. I want to know why he knows the name.
Do you ask him that?
Yeah. Well, I mean, I'm just trying to gather if he's like hiding something about that name because you never said his name. Yeah, he is.
he is
a common thief, but still, he just gave me a very bad description.
Oh, a very particular
individual. Well, I mean, how many dwarves are running around in a dress?
What he learned. So.
Same difference.
Right.
Little people.
You do, from what you can tell, you do know it seems a little strange. Like, that immediately hits you. It's like, you never said his name. And the way he just so nonchalant says, like, I'm saying his name.
Now you hear Sabadat coming down the stairs. Well, in your defense, they are in class. There, helps you out.
No, it actually is like, it's just a dirt ramp. Like they don't even have done like a pretty public stage.
So now I'm here.
I'm gonna try to lean into the pole for you.
For the sake of people watching, you should talk. What's going on?
I don't know.
Here's your cast friends. This totally can't come back to us.
Actually, hold on, I have something for this.
Did we find anything down here?
These people here, this kind gentleman offering great service.
Well,
thank you, by the way.
I have an ability that gives me the aura of my patron to either charm or frighten creature.
Fucking seriously?
Yes.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah. So I'm going to try and charm him.
Yeah,
I have charm first as well. Like,
so scary. Charming long time.
Well, okay, so it's not an automatic charm. DC against my spell.
What ability is it?
It's charisma based.
Okay, outside of the fact that, like, what I know, don't even roll!
Well, it's you that roll, but...
No, I can't beat that. Not your capability.
Alright, so just...
Yeah, it's a god's capability.
Yeah.
Cool! Patriot.
If I may, Nate. That's so fucking cool.
Right. So what are you doing?
You know, Nell's been a problem around here, and maybe he's been helping with you, but certain things need to be looked into. We need help here. Can you help us?
I don't know what you mean.
Really?
Inside.
I don't know what you mean.
Damn it.
As you start to absorb your control, you actually... Make a quick perception check.
Oh! Happy 20! I'm good at perception now!
Okay. As you start to exert this control, and basically you can tell you're sort of control over him and try to get him to be truthful and honest, you see it like your power flowing to him, and it's like, it's almost like it's causing him to malfunction. Like he's just like, deadpan face, just blank eyes, and he just starts not being able to not say, I don't know what you're talking about. Like, he just starts saying kind of rapid fire, just, I don't know what you're talking about.
Take this to you.
I don't know what you're talking about. And then he just kind of takes a step back, and everybody make a quick perception check.
I don't trust you.
19.
12.
16.
17. Is that everyone?
That's true. 14.
Everybody above 10. You notice now everybody else down here has stopped what they're doing and is now watching this exchange.
These are kids.
Have the kids stopped working too?
Yes. All 8 of them have stopped doing what they're doing and are now staring deadpan.
I can't believe I'm asking this to be actually useful.
Can I make an arcana check on the room in general to see if there's any magical thing going on here?
I'll save you the trouble.
Okay.
Here's Zerlo say, none of them are here.
Yeah, I was gonna. That was actually my next thing I was gonna ask Zerlo.
As he basically uses the ability that he gave you and shows you that, like, not only is there no magical aura, which there should be at least a base level.
Sure.
Like basically the circulatory system. Look,
yeah.
The 4 adults have nothing.
There's just nothing.
There's just nothing going
so
on.
So it's not...
When you look at the children, it basically looks like instead of an aura, instead of a circulatory system, it's just...
So it is magic.
Kind of.
Which, by the way, I rolled a 21 as Marvel.
Yeah.
So it's magic.
Basically,
what I'm gathering is that these things, in a way, don't exist. Well, like... Oh! What, you said fire?
Yeah.
There's something I'm bringing up. You can see aura? And what I just did?
He wasn't looking. He has to say he wants to use that.
Okay. Oh, my God. Hide more of my shit.
Zerlo is paying more attention to the thing.
Yeah. I don't know that part.
So, good or bad? Yes or no?
Bad. Cool.
That's ready up.
Yeah, and... there is none of these... No one's here. I'm saying this in a whisper, obviously. Mostly just the nods at this point, though.
Cool.
Yes.
Yes. I think they might be the same type of fire as you just love. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Cool. So, ready up.
Ready? Come on.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
I just farted. That one. Oh, how about you guys? Fired toast tools.
Yeah.
He's charged. You have the one that charmed, right?
Yeah.
All the adults in the room are basically just minor illusions, right?
There's nothing right there at this point.
Yes. Yeah, there's nothing there. Why hold it?
Banner change.
Banner change?
Yeah.
Pause.
That's what I'm actually giving you a second.
ISP.
If you want to buy stuff, go to the Aspire Tool School. You can save 25% off using promo code
AURA. Ooh, good one!
AURA.
Perfect. Good one.
AURA!
AURA!
Not AURA, AURA.
Right now, this is great. You don't give a flying fuck about me right now. And I'm out here saying, you let me get you.
Are freaking out.
That's so fucking cool.
Oh, I think I'll be alright. This is all I'm getting rid of. I'll just use the same basic space.
Short roll on this.
Dark vision, can you guys see the bottom?
Yeah,
sure. I wasn't sure if it gave me something else. I was reading up on Warlocks, so there's an insane bump you can do where you can see through natural darkness as well as cast darkness. Cool. So you can just be in the middle of darkness. Nobody can see you, but you can see everyone.
Oh,
that's sweet. I can't wait till I can do that.
Okay, then don't either. As far as I know, he just came down the stairs.
I roll up next to him.
Okay.
Because that's why I was relaying the information. I'm pretty much right next to the box.
Aw, that's so cute.
Yeah, this is so obnoxious. I can't decide which ones to use. It's fucking annoying. I suppose it really doesn't fucking matter. I'm just fucking. Okay. Oh wow, that actually worked out a whole lot better than I was expecting. That's funny. Fuck you.
That's probably why I don't remember much of last session.
No.
great idea. Let's get drunk. Yeah. Trying to play a game that requires lots of math.
So, while you're all sitting there deciding, Tomet literally just walks over,
pulls out the handle of a sword, it lights up and just literally just jabs it right into this thing. And as he does it, you watch this thing not only just not react in pain, but its whole body just kind of like withers and turns into like this gray humanoid mass. It just looks like a person, but with like no hair, no features. Just like a humanoid shape.
It's human clay.
If anybody wants to make an history check, you guys can do this.
11.
You have read about these things. They are a construct referred to as doppelgangers. Basically, these beings can be disguised as any normal looking of whatever species it's based off of. Like humans, these ones could look like any other style of human. As Talmud plunges his blade into this thing, these three also change. Make quick perception checks.
Five.
18.
18. Five? 15. Okay. So everybody above 10 suddenly notice an excessive amount of light behind you. The three of you that actually got above 10, really quickly as you notice this, kind of glance over your shoulder as you watch the children pretty much melt away. They melt into like this. They melt into this small shape that is distinctly humanoid, but its skin looks like reddish stone, with fire coming out of its hands and head, and a distinctly goblin-y look to its face. If you would like to make another, anybody who wants to make another history check.
18. Natural 20.
6.
That's 3 tonight, baby.
You have both heard of these specific styles of fiends. They are referred to as... They are a style of elemental called the Magmen. Yes. Natural... Well, just so you all know, the children have melted into that.
Oh, fuck. That's frightening. Shit. All these four right here did?
All the four behind you have now turned into those things. And now, roll for initiative.
Yay!
Oh my
That's not
God.
That good.
Never mind. Shite!
We are great tonight.
You rolled a shite?
It's an eight.
Eight?
Where's all the game copies?
Oh. You have a crazy boss.
I do. I have 12. I want to re-roll my initiative now. I'm going to get higher on the list.
Ryan.
8.
8.
12.
Jesus. Pass.
15.
Power 1.
Nat 1?
Yeah. J! Got a J!
The three of them in front, they didn't change anything, did they?
Yeah.
Oh, they all
three
back
more.
Okay.
Three more doppelgangers.
Oh, those are three doppelgangers.
Yes.
Okay.
Four and back.
Yeah.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Whatever I actually do.
God,
I wish I would roll higher on that.
Oh!
I wish I would roll higher on that.
I rolled the
shit.
Did you just get
no. I've been recording for 59 minutes. I think I've been talking to my kids. How do I see it?
Okay. Now an hour. We just an hour.
Yeah,
and
25
minutes without Jess.
Oh, what'd you get on your initiative? Oh, that's right, you're going.
Thanks, Adrian.
You're hanging out with. Thanks.
We can use that fucking pixie right now.
I'm hanging out with your new servant.
Call her. Shut your mouth.
Give a little whistle.
Call
me,
maybe.
What's up, maybe?
Thank you.
And beats.
Nine bones and a
heart. You're replacing them? That's what I was trying to say. But it'll be painful.
Oh, God.
What are you expecting? Pumpkin juice?
You can get
them on
time.
Little did she know that she spawned an entire generation of pumpkin spice lattes.
God.
Thanks, Harry Potter! Actually, no, thank you. I love them. Which, by the way, do you, Johnny Depp, actually use Grindelwald?
Yeah,
no, confirmed. That's fucking awesome. And now they're talking about actually having Richard Harris's son play young Dumbledore. At least it's
that's
what
legit.
A lot of people want. It's not even like a thing they talk about. Everyone's like, yeah, it'd be great. And I'm like, oh, yeah.
No, you have to
just trying to make conversation while we're waiting on that.
I'm sorry.
No, you're fine. Silence is not fun when you watch stuff.
Hi, Kai.
You okay there, Nick?
Hi.
We're kind of running low on battery on this one.
Like down to, like, low.
So should we maybe next?
How long does that go?
This could take at most a half an hour.
This one does not have that one.
Okay.
Can you plug that into a power source?
Let me see if the power source is here.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I'm done prepping, so I'm ready to go. I'm already rolling for shit anyway, so.
If we could just get to one, we'd be fucking perfect, I think.
What kind of power does it take?
Specified when we're getting ready to.
You brought your whole tower? Jesus. Nice. Well,
I'm editing.
Okay.
One of these 12 volt,
Oh, it's not like I have an extra
one. No, I don't think they...
So, you think we can make it 30 minutes?
Well, this one, no. That one will keep running, though.
Okay.
Well, this one will probably stop. We'll go all the way to the end, but that one will keep going.
Okay.
So, I mean, once the battle's done, we'll call it.
Yeah.
So, sound good, Nick?
That's fine, yeah.
All right.
And just keep an eye on the zoom. I can't see it from here.
So how's that rolling?
We're good there. All right. Kay. Shit. There goes my plan.
Okay.
I always have a plan.
Okay, so the Magmin, for its first attack, literally all you see it do is start creating fireballs and just throwing them at the bottom of the orphanage.
All these motherfuckers.
Oh!
Trying to collapse the
orphanage. Shit!
We don't know.
That
changes even more things.
Oh, God.
Yeah.
I don't know which part. I don't know. Where are the supports to the orphanage?
Basically,
things on the scene.
Oh! It's a cross-member system, but there are a few major supports.
Yeah,
Okay.
Going back to plan A.
Ooh.
Wait, the magmen are doing that?
Yep.
Okay. So the doppelgangers are just moving?
Yep.
I think they'd be grateful I fixed their sign.
Thank God,
yeah,
man, you
they
can
really
sports.
Care about that.
It's just the entire combat. Men.
It's his offer helmet.
Yeah.
Ooh. Is he just like...
It's the answer, so I could keep doing that.
Okay, L. Okay.
With my cool magic sword, or magic dagger, Chris.
Dagger of Daggerton.
15?
Yeah.
Yay! Okay, so I have 2d4 and a d8.
Remember plus your strength.
Was casting
dagger. Okay. Seven piercing, how much poison?
The D8 was poison?
Yeah.
So it's one piercing, two poison.
Okay,
no.
So seven total damage. I just realized poison doesn't matter. So,
well, yeah, it's
seven total
seven
damage.
Seven total, yes.
Okay.
Actually, no, it's five is piercing, one and two is.
Okay.
I can do math.
No, that's.
Okay, Knots. Did you have anything else?
No, that's.
Okay. Behind it?
Yeah, right there. And I'm going to try to target these two fuckers.
Okay.
With the core, I'm going to have it be the fun sniper mode, and I'm going to use a Deadeye shot during one of my grit, aiming for that guy. See if there's fire. I'm going to slightly gather out of the inventory slightly for resistance. But overall, firing away at these fuckers.
Fire.
Okay, roll the hit. Okay.
That's just as good.
12, 8, 22
So you fire, and it explodes on the magmen. Okay. As you see it explode, and the smoke fade, it does not look even remotely phased. You can now gather they are 100% immune to fire damage.
Oh, that sucks.
You can also weapon, but they're useless.
Still not good to use.
Anything else?
Oh, I'm gonna do something.
Sepetin.
Oh, fuck me.
No thanks, I'm good.
Yeah, that's gonna be my fun time.
How many spaces is it between those two right there? Like, if I were to do something with a radius.
25.
25? Fucking help me. I guess I'm just gonna go for this. I'm gonna be allowed. So I can get a little back because he's in my line of sight, so I'm going to move probably about right there. And then I'm just going to cast Ray of Frost at him.
Okay.
That's the best I can do. That's level 1 again. That's going to be a 17 to hit.
Hit.
Oh, that was really good. 14 cold damage to them.
You freeze and shatter it.
My explosive shot helps.
Sure.
All right, anything else?
That's all I can do.
Okay.
Did I notice if it was because of the cold?
Nope.
Okay.
Not specifically. You just know you didn't have damage to kill it.
Okay.
You will. I will point out the fact that it did seem to take specific. It specifically actually took the damage legitimately, unlike it sloughed off his damage.
Sure.
For whatever that means. Okay. Let's see, which one was it? Four. You're done. Fuck you. The other two specifically start doing the same thing, just giving you that creepy maniacal face as you saw in the book, as they just start like throwing fireballs everywhere. And at this point, you do notice the fire is starting to spread just a little bit. Make perception checks really quick.
18.
18.
9.
17. Anybody over 10 can start to hear, like, screaming and running from upstairs. Jay?
Can you go same thing that Nas did about the opposite door?
That one?
Yeah.
Okay. Where were you? 5, 10, 15, 20, 20, 30.
And I'm going to...
I can't use it.
I'll just blast the... No.
Second.
That way one.
The farthest one?
Yes.
Okay.
Shit.
Natural 20.
Nice. It. Your blast causes it to just explode into like little magma-y chunks. You realize that when you do kill it, it explodes into like little piles of fire, which are not doing much considering it's just a dirt floor. All right. Yep. Nope. Mother, get on the paper. Okay. Is a 12 hit, L?
No.
Okay. Mother, stay on there.
Adrian, oh wait, you're not
here. God, we can use it. I don't care.
I'm not believing I don't know how fast it's finishing. That's
yeah.
I can't wait to give him so much shit after
he's just standing outside watching the orphanage burn to the ground. They're fine.
Luckily, I locked
the door. I'm just talking to my little fairy friend.
Elf.
I locked the front door.
Your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna
stab you
again.
Oh,
shit.
12. Miss.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Nuts.
Yeah, I
shot him.
That far.
Okay. Yeah, that's it.
Where are the flames? 8 points damage.
Which one? This one right here?
Yes.
Yay!
So this one specifically has fire now on the ceiling of the boat. Yeah. About there. These two have thrown fire here and here.
Oh, man.
This one threw over here. And say it threw it in kind of the same area. So.
How many
is
it?
Six. Like it's like yeah.
Also, it's not
right. Okay. Is that it there, Knots? Okay, so separate 10.
I'm gonna give it a fucking shot. I'm gonna use Gust of Wind and try to extinguish all these flames. It's 60 feet, 10 foot wide.
Yep.
I'm gonna try. I mean, it's not against the enemy. I don't know how much I'm gonna roll for it. I just, without hitting a creature, it essentially just happens.
It's a 60 foot line of wind?
It's a 60 foot line of wind, and to clear up, the gust disperses gas or vapor and extinguishes candles, torches, and similar unprotected flames in the area.
Okay.
Which I would consider those unprotected flames.
Right, okay.
So that's what it is. So 60 feet, 10 foot wide. And I'm just going to fucking just straight ahead.
Okay. What level of a spell is that?
Yeah, it's my last second level spell.
Okay. So you manage to put out a little bit of it.
It was 60 feet?
Yeah.
And a little bit helps.
They're not torches, the big thing.
We'll also have a small field to kill them. Then again, I don't know shit.
Well, it's actively already doing damage in a small amount of time. It's spreading really quickly. I mean, yeah, the idea is that considering how rickety and awful this place is, it's literally it's a fire trap.
I'm gonna toss this out. I mean, I know I just did my action. I don't even know what this would do. But can I use a bonus action to try to conjure a bucket of water?
You have that spell.
It's conjuration. It's minor conjuration. I can an inanimate object. Up to 3 feet and all that, I mean, just a bucket of water, try to throw it in the fire.
You can conjure a bucket.
Yeah, a bucket.
You can't conjure water.
I can't conjure water.
Specifically. No. Yeah.
All right.
That would be considered an element.
Sure.
Short lesson.
That's
fine,
I'm done. That's all I got.
Okay.
Fuck.
Yeah, no.
I won't let this orphanage burn!
As the two magmen go again. Okay. Where is that on initiative? Oh, okay. Ferris?
Go for another blast.
Okay. Hit, roll for damage.
6.
What?
Okay.
That's all I got.
Okay. So as this entire rotation comes to an end, fire has begun to spread a bit more.
Hey Matt, have you gone over what the gem shaped
no.
We just know that it will help in needs.
Tell him I gave it to you.
Whatever. We all know right now, which is the important part.
Do something with it. It might do something. That could really help us right now, because
throw it into the fire.
Please God, do not throw it in the fire.
I'm gonna throw it in the fire.
Tell him just like takes his knife and just cuts his throat. I'm like, I quit. Oh. You guys are fucking idiots and the worst people on the planet. Hope you all burn now.
You see what I just got? Of course I'm the worst fucking person.
Okay. Top of the order now. Yeah, God. I love it. Ooh. Oh my God. In heaven, does a 9 hit? Sweet Jesus, Tomlin.
I'm so angry at this fire.
I love it. I love it.
I just hate it because there's nothing I can do about it. I can't do shit.
L.
Do you have anything?
Okay. You're the 77.
Hit.
Yes.
Pocket sand and fire. Show him his pocket.
It's a little thing. I mean, it's like a bag of sand. It's like a ball sack of sand. Just not enough of it.
So pretend you use ball sack of sand.
Not yet. But the idea that I mean, after you said that,
that's
11. Ooh.
Yeah.
Sassy.
I tried.
And ooh, I'm going to use a bonus action to disengage.
11?
Yes.
And I'm high.
Okay.
So bonus action, disengage, and I'm going to run towards the exit.
Okay.
Are you bitching the fuck out?
I'm going to go save the children.
Oh, yeah, the call.
Make a perception check. Actually, before you. Everybody.
Okay.
So who got above 5?
I did!
Okay. Everybody can specifically hear the sound of people rushing people out of the building above you, including a very familiar voice and a very small, squeaky little girl voice. As you can tell that Hadrian and Neely are helping to get people out of the building.
You did something, gents. Good job, man.
Way to go, man. Oh.
Do you still want to move towards the door? Knots.
Curve box the same motherfucker. And I am going to burn another grip.
The one at the back.
Overall, that's 19.
Hit. Don't even bother. Got one hit point.
That's a kill. That's another grip.
Okay. Ryan.
This is something that I'm actually curious about, and I'll roll for it if you need me to. Can cold damage freeze or put out flame? No? Fuck that idea then. Attack that bitch.
The other magman? You run a better chance of damaging the wood.
Yeah.
Which is not impossible, like in all honesty. Damn it, like freezing the wood would cause whatever it is, but if you're thinking like Ray of Frost, that's like a fight, like a small piece.
I know.
Because it's like a beam.
I know. So I'm doing Ray of Frost on that guy.
Okay, roll a hit.
Natural 20.
All right, don't even bother. Things have a whopping 9 hit points, and he was at 3, so you want to roll just for the fun?
Yeah. Did I crit up?
Yeah, you did crit. It's 20.
Scary. Okay.
It's like I almost did do it. But yeah, so he's... So he's out, so all he has is the doppelgangers?
Yep. Son of a bitch. Stupid ass doppelganger.
I don't have nothing to put on these fucking flames!
I got a sweet gun.
Just out of curiosity, after I did that, can I move forward? Is that okay?
Yeah.
Just like 20 feet. Get away from the flame.
Right. Okay. That's all that stupid ass doppelganger just vainly attempted to hit Talmud and punched itself. Okay. Varys. You do hear creaking and crumbling coming from pretty close to near you at this point as the fire spreads across the roof above you.
Move forward 30 feet through the exit, I guess. And kind of at an angle.
This way?
Yeah, somewhat close to him. Right next to him. Okay. Well, that's it.
Which one?
The one right in front of Talmud. The one close to me.
That one?
Yeah, actually. See, there was one. Do you know that religion one?
Okay, yeah. I'm going to do this instead. That way you actually have one inside.
Okay. 17.
Hit, roll for damage.
13?
13 damage overall?
13 damage.
Okay. So, as you guys finish this round of combat, This entire portion of the building has now crumbled down into this underpart area. Knots make a Knots and Sepetan make perception checks.
18.
21.
So you guys can now see that the fire has spread to upstairs as well and whatnot, so it's already spreading into the main portion of the building.
In that pile of rubble, can I see if there's anyone in it?
What was your perception then?
21.
There's nobody in there.
Good.
You can't see, I mean, despite the fact that this is like just bare stone wall, you don't see any traces.
The air is getting hot in here.
This might sound obvious, but I think we should take these guys out and get the heck out of here!
As well as this portion now crumbles as well.
Ha!
Okay.
So, let's go!
Top of the order. Christ. Ooh, that's unfortunate. Does an 18 hit L?
An 18? No, that's not.
Six damage bludgeoning. Okay. Is it just like... Okay, and then Talmud. Ooh, yeah, that's unfortunate there, Talmud. Good job.
We need you right now.
Dick bag. Walk on deck bag.
Don't worry, I'll save us all. Now! We need your help.
Can I shoot
you? Alright, L.
I need help.
Gonna stabby stabby again.
Savvy.
20.
That's it?
Or actually, technically, that would be 22. But
so you
critted?
No,
I did not crit.
Nine?
Yeah.
Okay, that's it, I assume?
Yeah.
Knots?
Action to equip
before. It's a bonus action.
Bonus action to put my pistol in and draw sword.
Yes.
Fuck yeah!
I'm allowing this as long as you are only carrying two guns at a time as actively readied weapons, that because you've been a gunslinger for so long, you can just quickly like...
Draw.
Yeah.
Perfect. I'm going to equip core. I kind of want to move forward, but I want to move at an angle where I'm still at range from this guy.
Okay.
I don't want to target.
What's your speed?
30.
Oh, I should point out that my speed is 40 now.
Perfect.
Okay.
I forgot to mention that.
Oh, dear. I'm going to pop this guy in the back of the head with war, or the core, I should say. And I am going to burn a grit.
Burn all the grit.
I'm okay with
it. True grit.
That is another 21.
Okay. Roll for damage.
Excuse me while I double check.
Thanks. Well, I'm borrowing this.
18 points of damage
on that one. Did I make a note on there about AOE? Okay, roll another one. Just roll a d6. Okay, add three of that. Take six fire damage, cast.
What?
What?
I am in kill with immediate regret.
Yeah.
That's like pleasure.
Hey, now we both burned her. Get the one that definitely doesn't like the thing you're using.
Right. Is that it there, Knots?
Yeah, good call.
Yeah.
All right. Sepetan. Which one? I'm sorry. This one?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead.
21.
That's a hit.
Grand Frost.
And it's dead. Comet gets an attack of op.
Kill him!
Hit.
The love of God, Comet.
Okay, I'm assuming a 6 doesn't hit you.
No!
Did Talmud miss him?
No, Talmud did damage. It just, it missed Jay. Right, Varys?
No, whip it. I just realized. Whip it really good.
What? Whip it with draw. Your speed.
I did that.
What are you doing?
I'm hitting it with a whip.
Oh, okay.
No, I told him before we started that I'm summoning the whip instead of my spears.
Oh.
I didn't, but you said you're readying a weapon, so I assumed you had a weapon ready, period. You change your mind halfway through the battle, I don't care. As long as you didn't already use it. 19 to hit, all right, roll for damage. Turn comes to an end.
Oh, really hoping we take him out in that turn.
Fire is now spreading a bit more violently, now wrapping around these two supports.
Look at that orange.
I know, like, I was looking at it on the camera. Fantastic. It looks like flames.
Okay.
That's some CGI right here.
As more of this entire back portion has now crumbled. Including parts of the wall pieces are now falling in.
Which side was the door? Oh, no, it was just below it. I was thinking we were below the main entrance, so we have to...
No, the main entrance is over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that just leads outside the building.
Yeah,
we went around
a lot. Right,
all right, so...
We got one left there, man.
That probably didn't even hit, I guess. Nope. God damn it, Talon.
God, Talon, useless tonight.
I will fucking kill you.
Why?
Drop a brick on it.
I'm upset.
Right. There, shut your fucking mouth.
Yeah, boy. All right, I'm leaving.
After he does that, he goes, "Everybody out!" And he runs over and basically pushes your ass fucking high speed out.
Make the run.
And leaves.
So, as you guys get out and run around to the front of the building, you do see that Hadrian has managed to get pretty much most of the kids, or a lot of kids out, and they're all standing a ways away. As you all take in the sight of the fact that the entirety of the orphanage is now burning to the ground, just nonstop.
I'm going to do something really dumb, and I'm going to run in and make sure that there are no more children in the building.
Okay, before you do that, Hadrian stops and says, "We got everyone. Everyone is accounted for. Just so you know."
She just wants to be.
Are you sure?
Aside from the four kids that were in the basement, which...
There were no kids in the basement.
Yes, but those things were posing as actual kids, which apparently went missing a long time ago. So we have gotten everybody out. Okay, yeah. How long have they been missing?
Yes.
The lady who you talked to earlier, who's just covered in soot, holding a very young crying girl, walks up and she says, "They've been missing for about a month and a half."
Can you throw them in detention?
I didn't in specific, the gentleman you went downstairs with did.
Oh, cool.
How long has he been working with you?
He's been working here for years. Why?
Wait,
what happened?
So
he was not
they didn't come out, they didn't come out with you. Where?
It wasn't real. It was an illusion.
It wasn't an illusion. It was a novel.
Well, of course not.
But, so you knew these children were missing, but you still took them downstairs.
She did.
Well, yeah, but obviously she still know where children were going. You'd be like, "I have to take this prevention. So-and-so.
You're like, don't those kids not belong here anymore?
Have you known they've been in there?
Yeah, she explains, he just told me that four kids were in detention. He didn't specify which four.
Well,
being constantly there working down there.
Some shit is just not happening.
Literal and insane.
Okay. She is 100% truthful. Like, to the point where she's, like, crying about this entire situation.
It's really, like,
where were the children going?
Huh?
Where were the children going?
I don't rightfully know.
Oh.
They don't have any place to go. It's just, this was it. Most of these kids are orphans from, like, parents who went off to war or died in bandit attacks, stuff like that. They have no place to go.
Oh, shit.
And I have no idea where they could possibly go anyplace safe.
What is the Superior game?
Superior? I think that's an 8d4
plus...
8d4 plus
8?
Plus...
Not in the book, actually in the dungeon master.
Okay.
Yeah.
I haven't written down on writing sheets. I don't have any.
Sorry.
No, that's fine.
You're good. Just we're at one.
No, I think we should keep going.
Forever.
I'm ready to go.
Superior is 84 plus 8.
Holy crap, okay.
I might have a couple of options.
Okay.
Where they might go. One of them, any of them I'm going to have to, ask around. I do know of a new room that's available at the Mages College that is very well protected. It's very possible I might be able to persuade them to hold you and the children for the time being. Well, I could possibly get some other arrangements, but it will take at least a couple of days.
Anything would work at this point. I mean, there's nothing else we can do.
I'll have to go to the Mages College. Would you like to come with me?
That's fine.
Are you sure the Mages will be?
If it could just be for a day or two, maybe. I don't know, but there's not a lot of options right now. Now, if I could...
Are you going to spoil the fun part, or can I?
Who wants to see a beholder?
That
of course not!
Little kids have no idea what you're talking about. They're like,
perfect!
I say this giant fucking smile.
Monsters are also very frightened from the fire, so let's just calm down
okay,
for a
minute. Oh, I'm perfectly
okay. I don't like frightened children.
Okay. So
that's where I would like to bring
before you do that, you do hear a and you're like, you look down at your leg and there is a crossbow bolt sticking out of your leg with a piece of paper wrapped around it, and you're just like,
in my leg?
Yeah, it's just like,
what the
fuck?
I
want to
make a perception check.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
I'll
search
with a piece of paper on it.
Oh, yes!
So I take the...
What is my
possession? Well, I'm gonna leave the arrow in for right now. I'm just gonna go...
22.
But I'm gonna take the piece of paper off now. I'm gonna read it.
Nice.
Yes.
You both notice it came from the west, but considering it's dusk...
Dark vision.
Yes, the sun is setting
it's
that
right
direction. Right. Yeah.
I think
that
hurts your chances of seeing.
Right.
I'm gonna go investigate.
I'm thinking dark.
Oh, hold on, and I read the piece of paper.
Don't care, investigate.
Hold steady for a second, man.
Dude, he's going off to like fuck up the dude that hurt you. Oh, he hurt.
So
you didn't feel a fucking thing.
Jesus. So As you read it, the note literally just, it simply says in some very quick scrawl, why won't you motherfuckers die?
Oh.
I've been doing everything in my power to get you to leave me the fuck alone. But fine, you want to end this? Let's end this. Come to the ship at pier number 7 and we'll settle this like men. Signed, Yellen.
And I roll it up and I hand it to Knots. He's speaking to you in particular. Can you read this? And I hand it to him.
Charlie, you're fine. Shut up.
I think someone has a crush on you. Don't you feel special? Okay. Not sure what I get from.
But, okay.
Yeah. Well, he shot you.
Gathering all the children.
It was a bad shot.
Trying to cheer him up. And be, like, happy.
So, that's our next destination after we take care of the children. So I say we head to the Mages College and see if we could possibly get them in there for now.
So you're taking the kids to the Mage's College? Anybody else going with?
I would like to find out if they would take them. If I can make it to the stag and possibly talk to some nobles there, I might be able to get them
so
another
which one
building.
Are you doing? Going
so
to the Mage's
where
College
are we taking
after we get them there.
I'm glad
the
you
Mages
used the same leg that took the arrow.
To the Mage's College.
Well,
go there first and see if they can be held there for a couple of days while I go talk to somebody else as well to possibly get them a new building. Stay with me. I know you're a little slow there, Nots.
Oh. Sassafras.
Wow. Somebody got balls.
Lightly, kid.
Well.
Try fucking lightly.
Don't insult my intelligence and just stick with me here for a second, please. And now I lead the kids off.
Okay. Who all is going?
Yeah. I'm going with the kids.
Okay.
I'm going to go take a very distant scan of the pier.
Okay.
See if I can just
I'm
going to
see if
I
can gather anything where that arrow came from.
Okay. All right, should we end it there?
Yes. I think we should end it there.
Well.
It's not getting that new game.
I don't even know if that one is running, but.
Just go look at that one anyways.
Is it running?
Can't tell. It's
dead.
All
right. Well, no one's been watching me, but. I've been fucking here the whole goddamn time. So.
When I reload the core, how does it. Is it basically just a charging sound?
Pretty much. It's that same, like.
so that's episode 5.
That's episode 5. Thanks for watching. I've been Matt with.
Ryan.
Nate.
Cassie.
Jens. And Jay.
Yes. Thank you for watching.